Soup for Dalren.
I'm gonna bring it over to the lady on the table.
Okay.
I'm gonna take a look at
And I'm gonna
Armstrong's,
like see if she's able to eat.
So she's not really conscious herself. You might be able to feed her. You certainly hear her stomach
Alrighty.
growling.
That's the plan then.
Oh
Okay.
fuck.
So
I
you're
the
kind of gently
acrobatics.
spooning the soup out of the bowl and blowing on it, and it's you're lifting her chin up a little bit and pouring it in, and it's going down. In the meantime, the bartender says, "Well, the whole total for this breakfast would be, let's see, about 1 silver."
All right.
Got one
Give some of the
silver.
meat to the blinded woman for her name.
So you turn over to Winona, and she accepts a few scraps of meat gratefully and
I
starts.
have to feed her it. I have to.
No, she's responsive. She's not.
No, she's bonded.
Oh, yeah, that is true. She is. So
Mind if
you're.
I just
I give
take?
the
bar keep 1 silver and 10 copper and say, thank you, keep the change.
Well,
Yeah, I bind her in the front so
thank
she'd be
you.
able to get the meat and eat.
Yeah, she would have to.
Oh.
She's just kind of sitting there waiting. And it's Ponzi
The
scheme.
faggot's back. I
I jump
jump
in
in
through
through
the
the
wall
wall
and
and
I
I say,
say,
fuck
fuck
you.
you.
Mute yourself. Why
What
is
the
it?
fuck?
I put I want to receive from mother's video only, but I got a
I
fucking
know.
audio.
Same. Maybe you get a refresh. I don't know.
Yella.
I kind of turn to Luke's meat.
Oh.
I'd like to make a check. Would that be
Obscene gesture.
investigation? Well, what do you want to try to glean from the meat?
What it is?
Yeah, that's an investigation check.
I just tweeted to her.
What are those?
Was it that 16 that just popped up? I was.
Yes.
Okay, so you start looking at the meat and you're kind of trying to derive what exactly is all encompassed in this meat, and the bartender comes rushing back out and he's like, you don't need to do that.
It's red herring.
Oh God.
Can I derive what this meat is?
Hey girls,
Go ahead
we
and
are
make an
feeding
investigation check.
You
Will
while you were
pickles?
gone. We role played you while you were gone.
Oh wow, all right.
There's a lot of countryness happening.
A lot of country.
Too.
Ow, nigger!
So
Fuck!
as it's going down your throat, you just taste
No,
how.
I didn't eat anything. I gave it to her first.
Okay, so it just smells wonderful to you. Your mouth is salivating. You cannot wait to chow down.
First time Brandon ever gave it to a girl. Look at her! That was good.
So I asked the bartender, perhaps I'd like to know what kind of meat that is.
Make a persuasion roll as he's kind of looking around a little shifty. Ten, and he says, "All right, listen." And he kind of pulls you both as you kind of both lean over the counter.
Can I make perception check what they're saying?
You can. So as he's whispering to Felfiz, go ahead and make. Yeah,
That's three twos in a row, by the way.
you don't hear anything I'm about to say. So he kind of leans over to Felfiz, and in his ear he says, "I don't know." And then
I turn around
he kind of backs
and I
off.
walk over to the table and just
Oh, that
sit
was a pretty
there.
fast walk.
It was.
I see Felfiz walk. I was like, if you did something to this meat, I will kill you without reasoning. Actually, I
And
do have a reason.
the bartender
Without reasoning.
goes over here and just starts shining up some cups and wiping them off.
I'm gonna reasonably kill you without a reason.
It's
All
about
right. But I do have a reason.
what time is
well,
it? 8:30 right now.
PM?
How does she react,
PM.
by the way?
Oh.
I give her the food. The meat. When I give her the meat to
Winona?
me.
When he give her the meat.
She's chowing down on it like she hasn't eaten in a long time, and you can.
I bet she is.
Yeah, I've already finished mine off as well at this point.
Okay, yeah, so Winona is,
Yep.
the color is returning to her face. She's kind of dribbling some juices down her chin.
Oh,
Oh my god.
Did you guys at
delicious.
least roleplay me getting some hot
Damn,
milk?
Luke.
No.
What?
You came right when everybody kind of went down for breakfast. You guys slept
Oh.
through the night.
Goddamn, Blair.
You called a lot of people cunts.
You came right when everybody went down.
I am under her hand. I'm by her hand.
Phrasing.
Nailed
it. Give the plate of meat to her, then I ask for. Then I say to the barkeep, give me a plate of fucking chicken, please.
And barkeep goes, very well. Was the meat not to your liking?
Oh, this is her. Come on.
He goes,
I chuckle from my table over here.
So the bartender goes back, and after about 5 minutes, he comes out with a beautifully fried chicken, and he says, just for you, 10 copper only.
Okay.
Can I make a perception check on the chicken?
You're kind of gleaning it from a distance, so roll perception with disadvantage.
I inspect it again.
It's actually black people meat.
Sure. Brandon, that is going to be a perception as well. With advantage, because it's right by your face.
Am I able to see if the lady's starting to come to?
So as you're feeding her and kind of... spooning the soup into her eyes start to kind of slowly open. She looks very, very tired, but she's finally now conscious. Luke and Marcel, yes, this actually looks like chicken to you guys. There's nothing very odd about this. It looks actually masterfully prepared.
I thought it was
going to be spit in.
No.
So, I eat the fuck out of chicken.
So this woman is now conscious. Not responsive, is just kind of leaned over looking at Dalaran.
Guys, she's awake. Come over here quick.
Guys, she's a nigger.
I'm gonna try to spot chicken.
Can I do a sick loot solo?
Absolutely. Yay. So you're busting out a kind of not so appropriate for the moment loot solo. It's very aggressive in nature. Multiple runs, even a couple tritones added in.
Man, can he roll a performance check?
Yes. I would say that is a good call. Go ahead and roll performance.
Do I get advantage or anything?
No.
Am I going to have to make a constitution roll?
No.
Okay. Well, does she have to?
Oh, damn!
So these licks are hotter than Led Zeppelin. You are just shredding away on the loot. It's very aggressive. It doesn't fit the atmosphere at all, but everybody turns to acknowledge your prowess over the loot.
I commit Sudoku.
Oh my god.
And from over the counter, the bartender approaches the bar and he flicks you 5 copper. Woo-hoo. So.
I nod and say thank you kindly.
And he says, bleh.
I thought you said I'd die.
Ponzi is now dead.
No.
Did commit Sudoku.
So this woman is responsive now, so.
Ma'am, do you happen to remember anything from last night?
I hope not.
I was just sitting in my home doing some knitting when all of a sudden this hideous creature bursted through my front door, and that's all I can recall.
Oh, that was Luke's mother.
Well, the hideous creature is in the room with you right now.
Don't fuck yourself.
And she kind of tries
to terrify the woman.
She tries to gently get up because she's laying down flat, and she tries to sit upright, but kind of reaches towards her ribs and lays back down again. And she says, "Well, is it under control?"
Oh, don't worry. Tie it up. You're fine.
Thank the gods.
So now I ask her, ma'am, would you like to return to your home? Or if you'd like to, we can... I have a bed... I have a room reserved that I'm not using at the moment. We can... Perhaps you should rest there.
Please, anything is fine, but just find my daughter. That's all I ask.
Will do.
You're gonna get some pussy, Simpkin!
I grab her. I don't grab her by the pussy, but I put my arm around her. Is she capable of walking at all?
Like hobbling no, you'll my need, sister? You'll need okay. to carry her. You can
then in my most suave manner possible. I
Use your dick to lift her.
Exactly. I swoop her up in my arms.
Swoop her up in your dick.
Is there any way I can like kind of like comp that, like kind of boost the moment for Simkin?
Give me a good smack on the bat, on the butt, just to.
Well, what do you want to do?
Good game.
I want to like play for him, just like a like the, just kind of like make it like a magical moment, more magical than it should be.
So like a Disney thing.
Can you feel?
Yeah, that one.
Oh, you're gonna feel this dick, don't you know?
All of a sudden, a very regal manner starts. A regal atmosphere takes over the room as Simkin gently picks up this lady and carries her upstairs.
God.
So are you taking
then
her
almost like a dance move, like we're waltzing? I just kind of
are you taking her upstairs?
Swoop her up into my arms, and I carry her up. Like my steps up the stairs, kind of like are with the music. Nice and slow, like. So I have her in my arms and I carry her upstairs into my room.
Beautiful. Okay, so she's now.
And then, like, Dalrin or somebody, like, acts like he's gonna come help me, and I turn around, I'm like, I pause, I'm like, I got this. Then I carry her upstairs.
So you proceed to carry her upstairs while you turn around and you glance at Marcello, and Marcello just nods and winks at you.
Oh, yeah.
This is like. This is like the billionaires trying to screw fucking hot models and such.
So I take her upstairs, the grandma, okay, Luke? She's a grandma, right? Or is this...
But you're also...
You were carrying the lady who lost her daughter.
Oh, so she's not that old, then?
No.
Yeah, the MILF.
She's like 30-something.
No.
You'll get the like 180-something.
Yeah.
I'm 150-something.
Yeah.
What am I?
No,
let me see.
The lady was that you carried was human. She was probably about 34
or 35. Does that
okay. Yeah, like, it's not like 100 years off.
So I take her upstairs, and I'm a gentleman. I mean, I'm a cleric. I'm like lawful good. Muhammad is watching.
Muhammad?
Muhammad, my god, my deity.
I heard
peace
Muhammad,
be with you.
Sorry.
Peace be unto you. So I take him upstairs. Take her upstairs. Lay her down. You know, maybe her dress gets a little ruffled, a little hiked up, and I avert my eyes, and I tuck her in gently, you know, nicely, and put a pillow under her head.
She. So as you
take her by the hand and give a little kiss on her hand,
and she just looks at you and says, "Oh, sir, thank you so much. You don't know how much this means to me. I've forgotten what was your name."
My name, good lady, is Simkin Thunderbeard.
I run towards the stairs and I scream, "Simpkin's gonna get that fat pussy tonight!"
The music stops. Marcello stops playing instantaneously.
I am absolutely flabbergasted, and I instantly turn blood red.
Is there any way
completely embarrassed?
Sexy song? Instead,
Bell's Whisper.
Fitting this hostile atmosphere, you play this song.
Oh dear!
A very marching order song.
I try to tell her in the best way I can that, not in these words, because obviously I'm a good person, but
better
that
yet, you play this song, I changed my mind.
And that, don't listen to her.
She just kind of looks at you and sighs and says, "Oh, children.
Stick your
children.
Dick
Wait,
in her
I'm
mouth!
169, bitch!
No, she's talking about Ponzi, she heard yell that.
The mountain king? What the fuck?
Alright, so I bid her adieu, and I back up.
As you
I
go to back out of the room, she kind of does that little, I'm going to demonstrate, she does the little hand close finger wave.
Like the rich person wave?
No, like the straight hand, bend the fingers down.
Oh, okay. Bye-bye. Gotcha. So, I gotcha. So I close the door, and then I go downstairs, and then I pass Ponzi, and I give him a little smack on the back of the head.
Okay.
And then I wink at him.
Harder.
I wink at him after I do that.
Whoa!
Alright, so I kind of like regroup with all these folks, and then I say basically, why don't we head on off to the apothecary? I don't know if you guys are all done with your breakfast.
The better apothecary.
What? Yeah, the better one. The one with a little experience. Doesn't just talk to squirrels and gather nuts, you know? So, do we need to, like, put her away? Should we lock her up?
It's up to you. She's still tied up. She's just
Can we put her in the barrel?
fed.
I suppose if you really wanted to, you could, yeah.
No, I'm just kidding.
Can we get fed to watch over?
Can you, turn on the music?
This music's getting dramatic.
Oh, you can set it individually for yourself as well.
Yeah, I'm gonna turn the music.
Oh, shit.
That was just turned off for me.
I talked to the barkeep. I kind of, you know, rap on the table.
Stick like, your dick in his mouth.
Yes.
Excuse me, sir. Would you mind watching over this woman? This is the same woman who harassed the town when she became a werewolf. And I just want to make sure that she doesn't turn again while we are absent. We have her bound, but I don't really want to, you know, lock her in a room or in a barrel or something. If you wouldn't mind keeping an eye on her, that would be appreciated.
Well, I wouldn't mind, and I also wouldn't mind a little supplement for doing so.
And he kind of nudges you and winks.
Yo, barkeep, you can have some werewolf meat.
He says, thank you kindly.
And he proceeds to kind of sit over here and wipe some cups down and wipe the bar down.
And wipe the old lady down.
I get up from my seat and I stop playing the lyric.
Okay.
All right, you guys. Are you guys all ready to proceed? Everyone finished with their breakfast?
I'm gonna grab the door.
I don't remember eating my bacon.
I don't know, dwarf. Are you ready to proceed?
Oh, Congola!
I was Congola. Born ready. I've been
I
ready for.
My bacon that I didn't eat, and I Congola with.
Okay, so is everybody ready?
Oh yeah.
Okay, and we shall proceed to outside.
Hey, Sheeny, your character's female, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Uh-oh.
No. So let me
there goes out there?
Let me do some cleanup here.
Ponzi skim.
And then I had Azani hidden. There it is.
You put your dick in the owl.
I did that when I was younger.
Okay.
I don't want to be a move.
Friend. Oh, well, you can go ahead. I was just putting you somewhere.
Don't worry, really know this. The black spots since there.
You're black, you fuck.
You do.
I'm gonna go check the apothecary shop.
What was that?
Oh, we don't even know the black spots. Since there.
We know where the apothecary shop is. We know.
Yeah, sure. Yeah. We have
you
the
can't
fog.
See in. Well, hold on. I can clear the alleyways, but some of the houses you can't see into.
But some of the shops
so we know
visited.
What they are already.
Yeah,
though.
Yeah, yeah.
Some
yeah,
of the houses.
Yeah. I'm getting on it.
We were in this dwarf shop.
It's difficult.
But we haven't seen in there. Day, so you don't know it.
I guess.
Yeah.
It's fog of war.
Pick. You guys can see kind Come of on. The edges of things, but areas you don't, you know, might have changed.
Is this door open? I go to the well.
Is that door open? No.
Yeah, I'm gonna knock on it and call out.
Does the apothecary seem open?
The apothecary does have some lights on inside. You hear kind of movement going on inside, but the door is locked. And then
it's locked. Okay.
Yes. Who else wanted to do what?
I'm gonna knock on the door and call out to the apothecary.
Well, just one moment. We'll be open right quickly.
We'd like to look to the north.
Okay, so in the north, you don't see anything really out of the ordinary. You just kind of see that the path continues on into a forest and then it's kind of covered up by trees.
I'm gonna look at this building.
Okay, so. is at this point that I'm going to take a bathroom break.
Sounds good.
So I'm going to put you guys on this wonderful page.
Oh, wait a sec, niggas.
That's a good picture.
Thank you, I drew it myself. And I will be right back.
Is this supposed to be in a mouse with like a butt cheek?
It's like a dick with a dick.
You, use your imagination.
The wait page.
What are you laughing at? Oh, my weight screen.
Upper wheel boy.
Okay. Is everybody present and accounted for?
Well, I murder the apothecary. No, I'm kidding.
Oh.
Well, right now, okay. You guys are in limbo looking at what appears to be a creature that is dick buttish in nature.
Is this perhaps the creature we saw in the well?
Can I roll initiative?
It's so beautiful!
No initiative is required, but roll history to see if this is the creature that you recall.
I suck the creature's dick!
Which one?
The whole thing is a dick.
Exactly.
Oh no.
14, 6, 11. 19.
Oh,
there we go.
Okay, so Luke and Simkin, you guys seem to have remember reading a book in your past labeled the Book of Memes. And this
Memes.
Motherfucker.
Okay, so Azani's description will be a little separate, but you guys have read the Book of Memes and you know that this is a formidable dick butt, usually gentle in nature, but provoked it may attack. Azani studying the
Would
wild.
You say it was a hard.
This is a history check, right?
A history check for Azani. You have seen one of these dick butts in the wild. Which is kind of, it seemed to be grazing on some.
Did
of the,
she vanquish it?
No, she saw the dick butt grazing on some lesser memes. Felfiz. So this you actually recall. Having a tapestry of the dick butt in your family's library as being one of the greater memes.
Azani, how would you tell me how experienced are you with the dick butt?
Apparently varying, judging by the 18.
You seem to be a person of quite a lot of knowledge of nature.
Of the dick buttery.
All of a sudden, the image of the dick butt flashes and shimmers out of existence, and you guys find yourselves caught back in the town of Greyguard.
Whoa, under the tree.
My dick is accidentally out.
So I think it's some sort of omen, some sort of sign from the gods.
It is a vision!
Go ahead and make a religion check.
From the evil god Mimlord.
Is it a sign from Tiamat or Bahamut? I don't know.
It's not a sign from any particular entity you know, but it does seem to come from the... It seems to be from the Abyssal Plains, a denizen from the Abyssal Plains.
Can I make a religion check to see if I've been possessed again?
Yes.
I can.
You can.
Whoa!
Ooh.
So
20 though.
You felt the influence of the dick butt trying to pry into your mind, but you easily resisted it, having some experience guarding your will.
Would you
Iron
say
sphincter?
It's like a penetrating feeling?
Absolutely not. So, more finding yourself back in the town of Greyguard. You guys are all kind of clustered in front of the apothecary shop. The apothecary shop actually looks like most of the rest of the houses in town. It's kind of stacked stones, mortared together for the first 2 or 3 feet, and then wood boards. There's nothing really denoting that it's a shop almost. It seems very, very humble. There's some moss growing on top of the roof, which... There's not really any moss growing on any of the other roofs in town.
Do they open the door? Or are we still waiting?
No. Last, you guys heard that you heard a voice say that they would be open in just a moment. You just hear more activity inside, but the door hasn't clicked open yet.
Are you still alive in there?
Check inside this building right here.
Give me one moment. Okay, so you look inside the building, and you see it's a storeroom. There's some sacks of flour on the sides. There's some crates towards the back with a piece of shattered mirror on this crate right here and 2 pitchforks in the corner.
Can I see if there's anything interesting in there?
Sure. So as you are kind of leaning in the doorway, you hear a sound from this direction, click, click, and the door lock clicks open, and the door swings open.
I'm going in.
And you guys are presented with an
a fat dick.
No, hold on, I have to grab an NPC. So give me a second.
Imagine it's a werewolf.
Oh, maybe.
A friendly werewolf.
Mm-hmm. Wait, is the wolf going to cure you?
Please don't be gigantically large. Sometimes when I pull NPCs out, they are monsterfully large.
Please tell me you have a dick butt NPC.
Wow. Wouldn't you like to know?
That it's monsterly large.
You guys see this small blonde gnome, you know, about 2-ish feet in height, older. The hair is blonde but almost white with a beard, holding a bunch of books, a bunch of bottles. Robot. And
beep boop.
Ah, la, la. Am I right?
Okay. So much better.
I just yell when that happens, so just tell me if while I'm yelling, tell me when I'm not robot anymore. So he turns to you all and says,
"Well, good morning to all of you, and welcome to the apothecary. How can I help you?"
Looking for some wolfsbane. Do you perhaps have any?
Wolfsbane. Well, let me go back and check my supplies.
And he goes upstairs for a moment. You hear a bunch of rummaging upstairs. You hear a crashing of crates, a couple bottles break. You hear him,
oh goodness, oh, no, not here, Wolfsbane. No, this is Thistle. Aha!
And he comes back downstairs and he says,
"Why, yes, I do. I have 3 helpings of Wolfsbane. Would you like to purchase?"
"Sure, what is the price?"
"Well, these are kind of a rare plant, and I really had to stick my neck out to get these. Each one will cost you 1 silver.
Could we do favors for it?
Rid your town of the werewolf infestation. So this is really charity on my behalf. If I was to create this potion, it rid your town.
Make a persuasion roll.
Think of the profit.
Can the bard play me some dramatic music to assist me?
Well, you can kind of lean back and motion towards the bard.
Marcello, I turn around and I'm like, I give him an eye and I'm like, "Over here, come on. Play me a song. Sing me a song."
I got you, fam.
And so, like, perhaps I tell him of some of the brave adventures we've been on in the past, and he's playing me some dramatic music, like some adventure music. I'm like, "We vanquished 1 werewolf, and who knows how many more there could be. We will vanquish them all and rid your town of the werewolf infestation."
So while you're talking, Marcello starts up this little tune.
Oh, perfect.
I do a little jig.
Go ahead and roll persuasion with advantage.
Yes. Oh, fuck.
Okay.
That's not too bad. That's not terrible. I have +0.
So, the apothecary kind of looks at you all and sits and thinks to himself for a second. And
well, I'll tell you what. I'll give you 1 wolfsbane for now, for 60 copper. But the rest will have to wait until you fulfill your end of the bargain.
I whisper to Simkin, "Why don't we just shoot him now?"
Can I just try sneaking past him and stealing one?
Sure, go ahead and roll stealth.
I step forward. Oh. I see what he's about to do in my lawful good. Goody.
Do you? He has to roll some stealth first.
Okay.
Okay, now go ahead and roll perception. For Simkin, roll perception.
Ha ha! I see straight through him.
Yep. So
and I take a step forward.
Dawn's trying to hide against the wall, and you kind of see him and try to put a stop to the shenanigans.
I step forward and
Simkin.
I have my money out, and I kind of put my hand over to block Dalrin's path, and I'm like, "We'll take it." And I pass him. What is it? 60 copper.
It was, well, make a persuasion roll then.
It was what, 10 copper?
Mm-hmm. No, oh. So you lean out and you go to hand him some money and he says,
I said 70, not 60.
Fine.
I heard you say 60.
I heard him say 60.
Let out a sigh.
Are you an honest shopkeep? Or are you running a shammy, scammy
very sort well,
of thing
very
here?
Well, 60 is fine, and he takes
I
the money
can't.
Out of your hand.
I will not stand by and be cheated.
Maybe next time you'll just let me take it.
He takes the 60 copper out of your hand, and he goes back upstairs for a moment. And you're not quite sure what he's doing up there, but he comes back down. Jesus, he comes back down, I said, roll 20.
But did he?
Thank you. Okay. He comes back down, he says...
Oh my god, what the fuck?
By the way, if I could help you out, there seems to be a cave to the north where all this problem is originating from.
It's probably not.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Of course, just remember to come here for your potions and other herbalist needs.
Absolutely.
You got any
so
weight?
I take the wolfsbane, and I exit.
Okay, so go ahead and mark the money and add the wolfsbane in your inventory.
I took the money away. I don't know where to add. Where do I add?
So for the wolfsbane, you can add that in your inventory, and then money is like the SP, the CP, the GP.
Yeah, I took the money out already.
Okay, okay. Just add one wolfsbane leaf in your inventory.
Under like equipment,
proficiency,
features, traits. I don't see like in.
Hold on. Let me see.
Put under equipment.
Yeah, go ahead and put it under equipment. That's fine. Okay, so are Felfas and Dalaran still in the shop?
Yeah, so I kind of walk up to him, and my game changes windows. Okay, so this keeps happening. I don't know why. So I ask him in Gnomish, what kind of things have you heard from this cave to the north?
Well, as you can see, my shop sits right here on the border. For the past few weeks, I've heard some mysterious howling coming from the north in the caves, echoing off the walls. But last night, I heard a bunch of movement and a bunch of loud, booming, rude voices going towards that direction.
Think about it for a second. Okay, thank you. That's all I needed.
Of course, we gnomes have to stick together, if you know what I mean.
Stick your dicks together, faggots! I yelled at.
Well, it's a gnomish.
Yeah,
you're right. You oh. Don't. Oh,
he still
okay.
Thinks they're speaking in gnomish, so he still thinks they're faggots.
Oh, yeah, it doesn't matter.
I walk to the north.
Okay, so are you guys going out of town now?
Wait. Before y'all go, hold on, I want to whisper something.
Wait, I want to check on the dwarf shop before we go.
Hold on, I'll just continue walking.
So, I whispered to the little gnome, got something that makes my dick bigger.
If you can give me just 2 minutes, I'll come back with something.
And he goes upstairs, and you hear some
because they're having a penis pump.
You hear a mortar and pestle grinding, and you hear some water boiling, and he comes back downstairs. I think he comes back downstairs. I said, thank you. And he says,
how much will it be?
I don't know this recipe. If anyone else asks, you got it. I'll give this to you on the sly for 20 copper. It'll only last for 20 minutes, though, and if it lasts longer than 4 hours, contact me.
Don't worry, I'm a quick shot.
And he kind of leans over and winks at you, and he takes the 20 copper and hands you a purple potion. So just put it in your inventory.
Was
the purple potion?
Was the wink anyway gay at all?
You perception. Don't. You haven't seen you didn't see this wink. You were outside.
Oh.
So 75 copper. Okay, sweet.
So.
Alright. Well, looks like we're gonna give this to someone.
So who else wants to do what now?
I wanna check on the shop with the dwarf in it.
Okay. so go ahead and enter the shop as you like. It's open, the doors open. You walk in, and the... Hold on. The dwarf comes out, and he says,
"Ah, well, welcome. What can I do you for?"
"No, I'm not here for anything. I'm just here to make sure that you survive the night, and everything's all well."
"Oh, well, thank you kindly. But as you can see, this place is pretty well fortified."
All of a sudden, you get stabbed.
"Well, all right, then. Farewell."
"Farewell."
So everybody else is heading out of town?
Yes.
Alrighty. Let me...
Give me one sec.
Well, I got a copy of all of you anyway. Yeah, I hope you guys know that realistically, you've been transporting to alternate dimensions every single time I change maps. Okay. So the entrance of this place is towards the bottom. There is a revealed area. And you guys are there. So as you follow the road to the north outside of town, the road kind of curves and bends, and it takes you about a good 20 minutes before you come to this area where the road comes up to the beginning of a cave. The cave is entrance is an archway, and right at the front there's four solid stone slabs with a tree over here and a tree over here. The rest is just grass, and then the dirt road that follows up to the four stone slabs. Oh, you can't see Ishin's name? Fuck.
Can't even see. I can't even see. It's all black, like Afra.
Yeah. Pop left.
What were these stone things?
Oh, is everything black right now? It shouldn't be.
No, it's not. No, I can see it.
Oh, okay.
It's weirdly positioned.
What's in a weird... Oh, yeah, I know. Just deal. Things... This part had to be a little ghetto rigged a little bit.
Got him.
Look at them pixels.
Yeah. I know. Just... So, Luke, go ahead, and as you're at the stone doors, roll perception.
7.
7? Okay, so you hear what sounds like male voices coming from behind the stone doors, but you can't quite discern what they're saying.
Oh, there it is.
Oh, it's an entrance to a cave?
Yeah, these are four stone slabs that are an entrance to the cave, but they're all the way to the top of the archway and all the way wide right now, but you can hear maybe three male voices coming from behind the slabs.
Could I do a perception check to see if there's any levers or anything around that may open the door?
Sure. Well, that'll be, actually, I take that back. That'll be an investigation check, because you're looking for something specific.
Can I just push on the door?
Yeah.
By a little bit.
Oh.
So go ahead and roll, and then Luke, roll athletics. So John, you're looking around trying to find some type of lever, some type of mechanism that would seem to open this door.
I'm going to do the same thing with the investigation.
Okay, go for it. So Luke, you're...
Just push it slightly. Keep it budged.
Oh, shit!
Nice. Okay. So Luke, you're pushing against the slabs, but they aren't seeming to budge. Ponzi, you see over here a strange section in the stone that doesn't seem quite right.
Hmm.
Can I see who's spying it? Can I make a perception?
I slightly kick it.
Okay. So you slightly kick it, but nothing happens. And Luke, you already you'd have to like lean your ear against the door and then roll perception again.
Oi, Simpkin, something looks weird here.
What'd you say, Luke?
I would like to see who, like, if there's any people watching.
I'll try.
Okay. So go ahead and roll perception. And then Darwin, you said what?
I'll try listening at the door as well.
Oh my god.
Okay, so Luke, you don't hear anything beyond what you already heard. Darwin, roll perception now.
Fucking hell, mate.
20. So you lean your ear up against the door, and you hear a conversation occurring between multiple people. You hear one of the men say,
"Well, they were just a bunch of instrument players. Who even cares about them anyway?"
And another voice says,
"Yeah, but we shouldn't have killed that many people. That was definitely wrong."
And you hear a third voice say,
"Yeah, but I liked the
the part when we killed them all. And the other two voices just say, shut up, Drew.
There's a group of murderers in there. I hear at least three voices.
Oh, wait, Simkin, there's something weird on this wall.
Can I do like a perception check on the wall?
Sure, go ahead.
Didn't he actually spot it out so he doesn't need to?
Well, Ponzi certainly did, but Simkin did not.
So you can tell, you can show it to him.
Show it to me.
Yeah, so now you see what appears to be an indentation of the wall from your training. Oh, Elf has died real quick.
Oh my god.
You're kind of getting the inclination that some type of magical energy might be able to get these slabs to open up.
Oh. So, What kind of magical energy? Do I have any inclination as to what type of magical energy?
Make an arcana check.
Alright, let me do an arcana check. Hang on one moment, people. Let me do an arcana check.
I hear pickles.
Yeah, I hear pickles echoing too, but I'm not sure how because I have them muted.
Then here.
I'm echoing?
Wait, sorry. Just talk, pickles.
Can you hear me now?
Okay, you're good.
I don't know why.
Okay, so you actually reach your hand out towards the indentation, and the second you do that, the stone slabs... I hope to God I don't fuck this up. Oh, thank God. The stone slabs retract, and you can immediately see inside... Ooh, hold on. You see... Oh my god, stop being so lame, game. You see
that rhymed.
Three bandits sitting there, and they immediately all turn to you. Everybody, roll initiative. Once I clear the list. Okay, go ahead. Yep.
Hey. Fuck.
19. Again.
What? Oh my job, god. Pickle.
Initiative?
Right. Why did it not? I don't understand why it doesn't put it on.
Click your character and roll initiative.
19, you cunt!
Mine doesn't go in there for some reason.
Oh, go to your character sheet,
need to add
click
that
your
macro.
Token, and click initiative.
You can also click, yeah, initiative from the character sheet works too.
Oh, thanks. Really?
It's abysmal.
There we go.
I'll take your 12. Hold on. Oh, and then let me... Do-do-do-do-do... Where'd it go? Ah! Aha!
Better roll fucking low. A shank a hoe. Well, not really shank, but...
A quick question, is the cave lit up?
Is the cave lit up? No, but the light from inside is providing enough to where you can see these three fine, strapping young adults.
Like, are there any shadows to blend in with, or...?
You could. You could go ahead and stealth along the wall if you hold on up.
Alright.
Why is that one in? Jesus, that's way better than I thought it was. Apparently, it does not want me to roll for these guys, so I will do it this way. Okay.
Dexterity?
Oh. Well, dexterity initiative is dexterity.
Yeah.
Okay, that was that one. Oh, is he gonna let me edit his turn? There we go. Mine.
All right. Wait. Where am I?
Nine. Okay. So, once I get this list ordered, top of the list is Ponzi Scheme. What you doing?
Without Nishartma?
Oh yeah, this is a rule I need to specify. When you're in within 80 feet or at 80 feet, you can attack without disadvantage. Past 80 feet is disadvantage, and I think it's 320 feet where you can't make the shot at all.
So, oh, okay.
I fucked that up the other time.
Oh, so am I... I don't know where I am. 20 feet.
You're good.
Alright, so I whip out my short bow.
Okay.
And I aim it towards the faggot in the middle.
Okay.
Alright, so...
You take your short bow and you go ahead and start drawing it back. Go ahead and roll your attack.
Attack. Which one is that again? The short bow, right?
Yes,
yeah. Am I doing it right? What do I click again?
You should just be able to click right on the short bow.
Alright, hold on, let me see. Short bow? Okay. Yeah, I don't...
Oh, I rolled initiative somehow. Oh well, that's interesting. So, here. I will pull it up.
I forgot where to click it again, because...
Yeah, so under attacks... Do the, how? No, on your character sheet, yeah.
Under oh, attack. I see it now. No, my bad. Yeah. Okay. It's normal, right?
Yes.
Okay, got it.
18, okay. So you pull your short bow string back and you let loose an arrow right at the middle guy and it slams right into his shoulder and he pulls his shoulder back a little bit and immediately rips the arrow out, but you hit him pretty good.
Really?
Uh-huh. So, oh, I can just do, I'm fucking retarded. Alright, next up is... Oh, do you want to move anywhere?
No, I'm fine here.
Okay, next up is Dalaran then.
I'm going to attempt to sneak along the wall.
Okay, so go ahead and... Let's see, you have a speed of 30. Okay, so go ahead and put yourself next to the wall. 14. Well, actually... Let me see something.
Mm-hmm. Or are these human bandits? Like, are they humans?
Human!
All of them are human in nature, yes.
Okay.
Okay, so none of the bandits seem to notice you right now. You are currently stealth along the wall. So you're moving behind him?
Yep.
Okay.
I'm right on there.
So as you move behind him, seeing further into the cave a little ways, you see what appears to be there. Oh my god, work with me, game. There, you see what appears to be their captain. Sitting right there. You're using the shadows to the best of your advantage, so he doesn't see you yet, but you are awfully nervous. Attacking would certainly reveal you to the captain.
I'm gonna pull back along this deep shadow here in the wall and just wait it out.
Okay, he is going to roll initiative real quick. Because this might change things. Boom, 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 boom. Let me add him to the turn order. Okay, so does that go ahead and end your turn?
Yeah.
Okay. So for some reason, Ponzi scheme got put in again, skipping over him. So now it's Bandit 3. So that is this guy. He is going to go ahead and attack the nearest, closest thing to him that he can see. Also trying to cover up for his buddies. And he's going to do... Oh, no, that's not Bandit number 3. That's Bandit number 1. Let me double check, just to make sure. Yeah, I was right. Okay, this is Bandit number 3, but he's going to do the same thing. And he is going to attack Luke. Do-do-do-do. With his scimitar. What's your AC?
Hold on. Should be 15.
Okay, so he tries to slash Luke with his scimitar, and the blow just kind of glances off of Luke's iron-trained body.
For some reason, cool. It keeps reverting back to 12, even though it's 15.
That's weird.
And then, I have unarmored defense, which is my dex bonus and my constitution.
He's going to use the rest of his movement to fall back to where he was.
Can I get a reaction?
What? Oh, yeah, you do get an attack of opportunity on this one.
Yeah.
It's not a reaction. Reactions are different. It's just an attack of opportunity.
That's fine. Will that count as my bonus action or no?
So this is technically classified under a bonus action, but all you can really do is attack, and then when it's on your turn, you have your action and whatever bonus action you have.
Okay. Just clarifying. Those problems was like, oh, that's a bonus action. Fuck, I can't do it.
Nah, you're fine.
8. Shit.
8. So you, as he's pulling away, you swing out with your great axe, and he just ducks as you would have severed his head, but he pulls down just in the nick of time and backs up to keep in line with his buddies. Now this brings us to Izani.
Okay, I don't really want to go in there, but...
You don't have to.
Yeah, I guess I'll just draw my battle axe and sort of take up a position beside Luke.
Okay, do you want to say anything to Luke or do anything else?
No.
Okay, that brings us to Bandit Power. Captain. What were you going to say? Were you going to say something?
Oh, no, a joke.
Oh, okay. Alright, so... What can he do? So, seeing... how one of his knaves is already attacked, he's going to move 1, 2, 3, 4, and he's going to attempt to attack Luke with his scimitar. So he also he tries to wield his scimitar against Luke, but the glow just kind of, once again, glances off. But he's sitting there right in front of Luke, trying to protect his men. This brings us to Simkin.
All right. I am enraged by their candid talk of killing people, and I run up beside this captain, and I cast... inflict wound upon him.
Okay, so go ahead and link the spell card and then link the attack.
Oh,
wait,
shit.
We heard that
from
what he was saying?
What?
I thought I was the only one that heard that. I informed you that there were murderers.
Only Dalrin heard that, yeah, but okay. Just for the sake of continuity, we'll say Dalrin passed that word along.
Hang on, let me...
Wouldn't that reveal self,
spell
though?
Card. Here we go.
No, he passed the word along earlier.
So. There's inflict wound, right?
Yeah, didn't Dalrin say that there were murderers in there?
Oh, he did, didn't he?
Yeah, I said that I heard 3 voices.
Inflict wounds.
Oh,
okay. So, you reach out and touch your hands to the captain very quickly, and your hands glow with purple, dark, shadowy energy as the wound opens in kind of almost a skeletal-like manner on the captain. He's now inflicted with this dark evil. He recoils from the wound, but he's still generally doing all right.
Fucking 21, fuck.
Give me 1 second real quick, because I did not link the bandit captain to his token. I can't see anyone's health all of a sudden. Oh, there we go. Okay. That brings us to Luke.
I would like to rage.
Okay, so you start screaming and slamming your great axe on the ground and fly into a fit of barbarian rage.
So if I go from here to here, would that be an attack of opportunity?
No.
Okay. I would like to hit for the guy in the middle.
Okay, so go ahead and roll your attack against him. As he sees this raging barbarian approaching him, he kind of cowers a little bit, but stands firm in his battle stance.
10.
So you are in your great strength of barbarian rage. You swing your axe with all your might down, but he just quickly dodges back to the side, almost crashing into Dalaran, but then resumes his position in the middle again. Do you want to use any more of your movement?
We'll go this way.
Okay. So he's going to take an attack of opportunity against you.
Really, I'm still in his 5 feet.
Yeah, but you pulled away. He's, you made a move to try to get away from him to disengage. It's not necessarily 5 feet strict. But he's kind of shitty, so... Ooh! So, as you're going to pull away, he swings at you with his scimitar, catching you on the shoulder and actually finding purchase. You take 4 points of slashing damage, but don't you have...
Shit. Yeah.
Yeah.
14.
Yeah, he rolled a critical.
He rolled a 4. Me too.
Wow. Okay. So, this brings us to... Bandit number 2. So that is this guy. So he is going to stay behind his captain and go ahead and move forward against Luke now. And he's going to try to attack again. Except, no, he's going to attack with his scimitar again. Okay, so this time when he swings down with his scimitar, he misses entirely. He was trying to aim for the area where his scimitar cut into before as a slight amount of blood was pouring down, but he misses entirely and almost stumbles into Luke, but stands back up, bringing us to Bandit 1, who is going to also attack Luke, seeing as he's kind of stuck there.
Wrong Bandit.
Oh yeah, this is Bandit.
That's 1. Bandit 3.
Oh yeah, I got him mixed up. Okay, so this is Bandit number 1 then, so never mind, that doesn't happen. He's going to attempt to find Dalaran, sensing that there's something in the immediate area, huh? Okay, so he's kind of searching in the area for something afoot, and he sees Dalaran now, and he's going to go ahead and try to attack him. So, finding Dalaran hugging the wall, he lunges out and slashes with his scimitar, catching Dalaran all along the arm. You take 5 points of slashing damage.
Okay.
Also, in your health bubbles, the red bubbles, you can just hit, when you have your number selected, you can just hit minus whatever and then enter, and it'll go ahead and calculate that for you. Okay.
Can you do that?
When you click on your character, do you see the red bubble that pops up? The red, the green,
yeah.
Blue?
The oh, is that health point?
The red is...
Oh, I see it. Okay. Red is health. Green is armor.
Yeah. Yours is 18? Jesus.
How do I check if I have any armor, like, against the slash?
That would be a resistance of some kind. That would be under either class or race. I don't think you do.
Okay, nope. Like, my armor wouldn't protect me at all?
No, your armor dictates your AC. So when you roll attack, your AC is what they need to hit you.
You're gonna dictate this dick!
So, this moves on to Felfez.
Oh, right, let's see. How far can I move and still take an action?
So the blue on your icon, the blue is your speed. So yours is 25. So you, every square is 5 feet and you can move a total of 25 feet.
Okay. So and you then can take
use
an
up,
action.
You can use up all your movement and still take an action. You just can't move past your movement.
Okay, cool.
Unless you want to dash.
So I'm going to run up over here and I will cast Eldritch Blast on this guy.
Okay.
And let's roll that.
Ooh.
And that one, though.
Ugh.
Both that one.
Yeah, so you are... you're channeling your beam, and, as you go to cast it, he sees you channeling the energy and quickly dodges up, which causes this guy to dodge up as the beam shoots off into the rock and makes a hole in the rock over here. They both resume their positions. Do you want to move any further? I don't know how much movement you have left.
I'll move back one.
Okay. That brings us to Marcello.
Alright, I'm going to draw my long sword.
Whoa.
Yeah, right. And I'm going to move up. I'm going to go 1, 2, 3, 4 up to the bandit camp and try to attack him.
Okay, go ahead and make an attack.
Wait, what? I might have done the damage. Wait.
It's minus one because you're strength.
No.
Why is it minus one?
It's a natural one and he has minus one.
Well, what's your proficiency? Did you include proficiency?
I did.
That's...
This is why I don't like using this.
It did the damage wrong, I think.
It says he ran the 17.
No, he hit the attack, but his damage rolled...
You should never do zero damage.
Right, it's one plus a negative one modifier, so we'll just call it one. So you
sure
go...
you didn't?
Hmm?
Shouldn't be right if you didn't add proficiency.
Yeah, he's got a plus two for proficiency.
Yeah, are you proficient? Well, if you're proficient with the weapon, it doesn't add any damage. It only makes you attack
it only
easier.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Oh, so you have minus one strength.
My strength is a minus one modifier.
That's.
Oh, so longsword strength base.
So we'll go ahead and say it's just one damage because I have pity on you. So you swing your longsword. You're kind of clumsy with it because fighting isn't necessarily in your nature. And you just kind of scratch his skin with the tip.
Ha ha!
Art thou trying to tickle him?
Yeah, dude, your grunt is like a turtle having sex.
Do you want to use your bonus action to inspire anyone?
I do. I shall inspire Dalrin.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, okay. I got you, boo.
So, how exactly do you inspire him? Please, try your best.
With your dick!
I'm gonna go with the age-old saying, Dalrin, you're the best. I've seen it.
That is a classic. They always say that back in my monastery.
So, inspired by Marcello's beautiful ballad, Dalrin, you gain +1/+6 dice on your next ability check or attack damage roll. Or attack roll. Which brings us to Dalrin.
So, if I get away from this guy, does he get an attack of opportunity?
If you move, yes, he would.
Oh, I'm not able to move my token.
Say what?
Are you on ruler? Yeah, you're on the ruler.
Oh, yeah, you're on ruler. You gotta switch back to...
Oh, yeah, okay, there we go. Okay, so I'm going over here. Then here. Oh, wait, no, I think I'll... If I'm here, am I still within his range?
Yes.
Okay, I'll go here, and then I will attempt to get this guy in the back with both my daggers.
This guy?
Yeah, that one.
You should get a bonus, because there's teammates nearby.
He doesn't get... Oh, wait, yeah. Wait.
Yeah, you should get sneak attack.
Yeah, you can go ahead and sneak attack this, because you have two people nearby who are engaged in combat with that person.
Okay, so...
this would be a sneak attack.
Wouldn't also be an instant crit?
No, it would not be an instant crit.
So do you roll attack with both daggers?
Yeah, and then you roll a 1d6 extra damage.
Mm-hmm. For the sneak attack, and then would I do another 1d6 for the inspiration?
No, 1d6 is only to make the attack, it's not for damage. So you can choose to use that or not. So
the sneak attack is for damage only, though.
Yeah, so go ahead and roll.
Yes, okay, so you roll an attack first.
Yeah, so your first dagger connects with the back of bandit number two, and he kind of screams and reaches and arches his back a little bit.
By the way, the second one does not get sneak attack.
Yeah. So you need to roll a 1d6 as well for the first dagger.
Yeah. So just go ahead and do /r/1d6. Okay.
Four.
And as you're trying to swing at him with your second dagger, you realize he is already fallen dead.
Oh! Weak sauce.
Okay, do you want to go ahead and
move? I'm gonna try and disengage from that, the bandit number one, or like the one in the red.
Okay, disengage is an action.
Or like get out of.
So he'll get an attack of opportunity against you.
Okay.
Okay, so he's going to attempt to swing at you. That is bandit number one. I'm getting confused because I messed up the order. Okay, so as you're backing away from him, he slashes at you with his scimitar, catching you across the chest. You take 3 points of slashing damage.
Oh, I'm out of it.
Okay, so now, after taking this blow, you have fallen unconscious on the ground.
Oh.
What a pussy!
What speed do you have?
8.
Okay, this moves us on to Ponzi scheme.
Alright. I put away my short bow, and I swiftly take out my daggers.
Okay.
Alright, I move on towards to this faggot over here. Is that alright?
Yeah, but make an acrobatics check, because it's a...
Oh, acrobatics?
Squeeze.
Oh, yeah, okay.
You're gonna have to try to jump and navigate around them.
Alright, acrobatics. Let me do that.
14. Okay, so you take a heroic vault in between and behind everybody, and land on your feet right next to... obligated bandit number three.
Alright, I proceed to slash him with both my daggers.
Okay, go ahead and roll that.
Didn't we do something like last time with the daggers? I forgot.
It was a 2.
Yeah, you just roll 2 attacks.
2 attacks?
Mm-hmm.
Alright, hold on. Okay, 2 attacks. Dagger 1, normal roll, and dagger 2, there.
So, after you vault through the air, you land right next to this, bandit. He looks surprised to see that you just kind of popped up right next to him in a...
Wait, does he get sneak attack?
Does
it run next to him?
Yeah, he does. Yeah. So go
to the side? Alright.
Oh, because I'm right there.
No, just roll another 1d6.
Oh, 1d6? Yeah. Is it for my dagger?
It's for your dagger. It's for your dagger, but it hits on
/r 1d6.
Yeah.
No pluses or anything?
No. 1. Okay. So you reach in and you stab this guy on both shoulders through with both of your daggers. He recoils and his arms kind of lose a little bit of strength and he's bleeding pretty heavily.
Like 1 HP.
And I end my turn there.
Okay, so now we are on to the bandit that you just attacked. So he's going to try and return the favor to you. I will go ahead and show you guys the rolls, because I figured out how to do that, so I'm fucking genius. 14. What's your AC? Your AC is 14. Ooh. So, after you stab him, he grabs both of his shoulders for a second, picks up his scimitar, and then go ahead and swings at your chest, cutting you open. You take 5 points of slashing damage.
Oh shit, 3 HP. Alright. Current hit points.
You've only got 8 too.
You can just, yeah. Like you said, you can click on your token, bring up the bubble, and just do minus whatever I said, and it'll calculate it. Okay, this brings us on to Azanai Stony Oath.
Okay, so I'm gonna make a two-handed attack on the leader here. Okay.
Save me, you lovable fuck!
Okay, so what? You... I know what it...
Don't laugh at my math.
Yeah, I know what it means. So you take your battle axe and you swing it against the captain, finding Purchased right into his arm, dealing 6 points of slashing damage. He seems to be still firm in his stance. Do you want to go ahead and like move or stay there?
No, I'll stay here.
Okay. This brings us to the bandit captain. Seeing that Azani just damaged him, he's a little bit angry, and he is going to... He's going to multi-attack Azani in a fit of rage. Yes, he has a multi-attack.
Wow.
One.
We're gonna die!
Two.
I'm not.
Three.
Okay, my armor rating is 13.
Yeah, so he's swinging at you with everything he's got, and the spirits themselves seem to protect you from his blows as they all just kind of shrink off of you.
Bahamut be praised.
He just kind of looks at you with a snarl and goes, "Oh, shut up!" And then he's going to sit there and still try to protect his men, because he's the captain, and that's what he does.
I am the captain now.
This brings us to Simkin.
I am the captain.
Look at me. I am
I decapitate his pussy. Wait.
I would like to
sock him in the dick.
Dalaran is unconscious. BT dubs.
Yeah, screw Dalaran.
Wow, just the blue guy now.
I will I'm going to cast Sacred Flame. Actually, no, I'm going to... Yeah, I'm going to cast Sacred Flame on... Sacred Flame on the dude, the big guy.
I'm a captain?
Captain. El Capitan. There you go.
Okay.
So he has to roll 13 saving throw.
Okay. So he's going to try to save himself as you conjure a pure pillar of fire in front of him.
Oh,
and he does not. So he takes oh wait, let me make sure.
Full damage.
Okay, yeah, I know. No, that wasn't what I was checking for. So he takes 8 points of flaming damage as the flames lick at his skin and then seem to extinguish themselves. He is still standing upright.
Okay, and then as a bonus action, I'd like to use my healing word on... Get it back to the spell card. Healing word onto Dalaran.
Okay. So go ahead and. Yep. Okay. There so we go ahead and roll that.
Alright.
So
7.
As good. You reach out your hands, a shot of green energy coalesces in your hands and slowly shifts over to Dalaran. Dalaran regains consciousness and. Breathe a sigh of relief as he comes back from being unconscious. Do you want to move or anything?
No, I'm good where I'm at.
Okay.
And I'm out of spells.
That is rough. So this brings us on to Luke.
We'd like to attack the captain.
Okay, go for it.
Hold on. plus 6, wait, 18. 19, yeah.
Yeah, okay, so that hits, so roll damage.
8. Four. 15.
15, okay. So, you bring your battle axe and you raise it against the captain, and as you swing with all your might, you lop off his head entirely, and he falls to the ground dead.
Woo!
Wah. Okay.
Am I able to run through this guy? Or no?
The body of the dead captain and Panzai and the bandit already being there, you are not able to run through him. You could try to
don't
vault
fucking
to,
kill
you
me.
Try to vault over him with an acrobatics check. You have just enough room in this cave to do that.
And what I wanted to do was just knock him over, but that would be an action. So,
yeah, that would be like, that would be considered a grapple, I suppose, which is an action.
Mm.
So does that end your turn?
Yeah.
Okay. All right, this brings us on to bandit number two, who is dead. Oh, wow, when I hover over people on the turn tracker, it tells me who they are. I wish I had known that like 10 minutes ago. Okay, so seeing two of his comrades have fallen, this bandit is going to back up a couple spaces, and he's going to bring out his crossbow, and he is going to fire at Dalrin.
God damn it.
You're dead. I get. Oh, never mind.
Hold on.
So, as the bolt shoots through the cave, the noise echoing off the walls, it catches Dalrin in the upper right arm, and you take 2 points of piercing damage. That will end his turn and bring us to Felfiz.
Okay, give me 1 second.
Sure.
One.
Oh, fuck.
I'll be right back 1 sec.
Yeah, while you're debating your action, I'm gonna take a quick pee super fast.
I'm close to making sunrise. No, twilight. I can feel it. It's almost there, lads and lass. Fuck. It's so hard.
What kind of character should I play in Skyrim? I usually play like
a fucking cat.
I usually play like a stealthy, like
everyone plays stealthy in.
Yeah, everyone wants to do stealthy. Do a fisty cuffs build.
I'm so happy I started up like special edition and preset it for ultra quality.
I mean, anything can run Skyrim at ultra.
Mouse potato cannon.
Yeah.
Okay, so what would you like to do?
Whose turn is it?
It's Felfiz. Is he there?
Hello?
Oh, yeah, it's, what did you say your action was gonna be?
My game froze, give me a second.
Oh, okay. I'm going to go ahead and refresh mine as well in this moment. Because I keep losing people's webcams and it makes me sad.
Oh.
I have egg rolls and that's it. Why don't I have anything else?
You like my shirt?
I have Brandon as well, but...
I do like your shirt. Your shirt's pretty sweet.
Oh, yeah, thanks, dude. It's my uncle.
Go wait for me.
Uncle Ben.
Oh, yep, Uncle Ben.
I have to scale my map.
Spider-Man.
Uncle Ben's cock, you know what I mean.
Alright, so there's one guy left.
Dude, you need this. You need the Star Trek one.
There's two guys left. There's this bandit who's uninjured, and this one who's currently facing off with Ponsley.
Oh yeah.
I want to finish him off.
I'm gonna move.
I want to fuck him right in the pussy.
Okay, a little closer. Move up here. And I lost my other page. I'm trying to figure something out real quick.
That's fine. That's fine.
Okay, my other page did disappear. Okay. So I'm gonna cast
my deck.
I don't have any such spell. I'm gonna cast a poison spray on the guy right in front of me.
Okay, so go ahead and click the attack. So DC, okay, so he is going to attempt to make a constitution saving throw. As soon as this is bandit one, right? Yeah, that's bandit one, okay. Ooh, so as you cast your poison spray towards him, the poison wants to take hold of him, but he kind of just shrugs it off. I believe in D&D we round down. Is that correct? Yes?
Round up.
No, I'm pretty
sure. Round down.
I think it was always round down.
I was going to say, yeah. Pretty sure it's down.
You always round down.
That's my thought. So he takes 1 point of poison damage.
I'm going to take a step back.
Okay.
You can't, that's your full movement.
Yo, Shinny, what are you going to show yourself on webcam?
You're at
what?
Yeah, you have 25, not 30. That would be step number 6.
Was that 25?
Let me... Oh, no.
From right here to right here.
Yeah, you don't move diagonally. You have to move counting the square.
Oh, okay.
But you can move diagonally through a square.
Right, but wouldn't that be 10 instead of 5?
Or is it like,
if you're moving diagonally through a square, it'd be half of the...
If you see where I'm at, you're technically allowed to go there.
Yeah. But then is that 5 right. feet or 10
Yeah, it's
feet?
5.
Oh,
it's
okay. 5. So yeah, you could go ahead and move back. Okay, so that brings us to Marcello.
No, there's not really much I can do. I'm just going to take a step back.
And... Inspire me.
You're right. I'm going to inspire Ponzi.
Okay.
So give me a second then.
Oh, here I come.
Draw the dick butt.
I'm gonna sing him a tale of dick butt, and hopefully,
No, don't say what you're gonna do, just do it, girl.
Do you whip your dick out and play it? Like a...
What I do is I take my dick out, and I, like, helicopter it.
Okay, so... Azani, go ahead and make a dexterity saving throw.
God.
I'm getting concerned.
What was that?
No.
Oh, man. So as you're not looking at it, but you... The shift in the air entails that Marcello is doing something you might not want to look at. And you feel a bit of wetness on your shoulder.
Oh.
However, Ponzi is inspired, so you can roll a 1d6.
What about Azani? Is she inspired?
If there was despiration, that'd be her right now.
Okay. I'm pretty hard right now.
But Ponzi is aroused by this very alpha performance.
I turned into a gorilla.
Not quite. Okay.
No, Ken Bone?
Does Marcello? Yes.
Ken Bone.
Does Marcello want to do anything else with the movement?
No, I'm good.
All right, this brings us to Dalren.
Alrighty, I'm gonna charge this bandit here with a rapier in one hand and a dagger in the other.
Okay.
So.
Okay. So, against your onslaught of fast attacks with the rapier and the dagger, you manage to poke a couple holes in him, and he takes 3 points of piercing damage. He's still... oh, Jesus. I entered that in wrong. He's still looking okay, but he's just got a couple of wounds on him for now. Do you want to go ahead and move anywhere else?
No, we'll stay here.
Okay, this brings us to Ponzi scheme.
Alright, so I proceed to hit the bandit in front of me with my daggers again.
Do it, bitch.
Alright, motherfucker. That, and that, and a 1d6, right?
Yes.
Okay. 1d6.
And do you want to use your inspiration die for any one of those attacks?
I want to use it for, yeah, the first one.
Okay, so just do /r/1d6. Oh! So, the inspiration that Marcello gave to you gives you just enough ability to go ahead and cleave this target right in front of you. Your first dagger connects with his skull, instantly bringing him to the grave.
Oh,
he
yeah!
Him in twain.
And he cuts him in twain. Yep, so all we have left is this guy.
Wait, I want to stand over to the bandit with my dick out. No, I'm kidding. I'm kidding.
Alright.
I'm done there.
This brings us to Azani.
Oh, my turn, Adam. Can I get over these two bodies here in front of me?
You would have to make an acrobatics check, but you could, yes.
Yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and do that.
Okay. So just go ahead and make an acrobatics check.
Okay, so damn!
Prepare yourself and you lean down a little bit and then vault clear over the stack of people meat. We'll say you land here for now and then you can use your movement where whatever you have left of it. So that would be... So you use 10 feet and you have 30... You have 25, so you can move 3 more squares.
Okay, I'm gonna move here and one more two-handed attack.
Okay, go for it. Ooh.
9 and 7.
That's rough. So you, the leap that you just took kind of saps you of some of your strength, and as you go to swing your battle axe, do you miss the bandit, who just kind of looks at you and laughs at you.
And his dick is hard. No,
you don't know that per se. But this brings us to Simkin.
All right. I'd like to move up to him. Let's see. One.
You would also have to make an athletic
I can
check.
Surreptitiously.
Oh, you could do that, yeah.
Sneak my way around here. Mm-hmm. And I'm going to attempt to grapple him.
Okay. So go ahead and make an athletics check.
Killing the son, bitch. Okay.
11 versus his...
Killing him.
Bum. Did it not roll? Oh, there it is.
Oh.
Oh, so you managed to manhandle him easily as he's kind of trying to weasel and squirm his way out of your strong dwarven grasp.
Right, I got the iron
hand. Squirts?
No. Okay.
So I now have him grappled, so I can move him however I want. My movement is done, though, so
yeah.
That's the end of my turn.
But you have him grappled, so somebody else... Yeah. If somebody else attacks him, they'll have advantage on it.
What the fuck are you doing, Marcelo?
This brings us to Luke.
So I do say, though, let me say that.
Oh, sure.
Before my turn ends, I say perhaps we should...
Nope, I'm killing this bitch. I don't give a shit.
Interrogate him. Maybe he has good information.
Who do you say that to?
Everyone, I say.
Okay.
Hands off! Let's keep him and perhaps he can give us information.
Hands off, he's cute.
Mine.
Okay, go ahead.
Hands up, don't shoot.
Go ahead and roll Intimidation, Simkin.
Oh, yeah.
It'd be Intimidate the Barbarian.
Intimidation.
What do I roll?
You're gonna... what would you roll? I guess it would be Constitution saving throw.
Like a
throw.
Charisma. Good to me.
Re-intimidate point.
Yeah, just roll a flat Charisma with your modifier, whatever you have. Oh! So, Simkin's words kind of bounce off Luke in his barbarian rage, and he continues on his onslaught.
quick attack.
Go ahead and attack, boy, with advantage. As he is in Simkin's strong grasp. His very manly, dwarven grasp. Fingers rough with the years of work.
Grasp. Yeah, he's finger popping his asshole.
20 and a 21.
Holy shit.
Oh.
Why do you get two d20s?
Advantage.
What?
Oh, yeah, that's right. Okay.
8.
So, yeah, just the syntax of that confused me.
Yeah.
You swing your battle axe, and as Simkin cries out, it's too late as the battle axe finds purchase in this bandit's neck. Blood seeping out as he falls to the floor with his life's blood still spilling out in pumps as his eyes go white and he is dead.
Are we still in initiative or can I make action here?
Nope, this will, once I switch the music.
I'll let it continue forward.
This will go ahead and...
Luke, don't run off. You can't move yet. You just did your action. So now I'm going to take my shield and I'm going to do like a shove on... I'm going to go back to where he originally was right there.
You're going
gonna
to
do
shove
like,
the
bandit? I'm going to shove Luke, yeah. I'm going to...
Roll strength check.
Yeah.
I'm going to
You both roll strength checks.
I'm a lawful good dude, and you just killed someone who I had as a hostage.
Yeah, you both roll strength checks.
Straight up murder.
So you go to try to shove Luke, but Luke plants his feet, and you just kind of brush your shield against him.
Can I loot the crossbow and any bolts left on him?
Sure.
I'm gonna loot the cannon.
So,
I'm gonna
loot the guy I murdered.
Oh, la, 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 la.
Okay. This guy's mine.
You find one crossbow and 10 crossbow bolts.
Okay.
Okay, who wants to do what next?
I'm gonna loot this guy.
Okay, and then Marcel loots the captain, and then we'll say Ponzi loots the guy in front of him. So, Marcelo, you find one dagger and 2 gold pieces.
You know who's buying dinner next time?
Felfiz, you find 3 silver pieces and a crossbow. And Ponzi, you find a +1 dagger.
Ooh, shit. Very nice.
Along with 10 silver pieces.
All right. +1 dagger?
Yes. It's in the book.
It's better than your dagger that you have.
Yeah, oh wow, no, I never knew that.
What's my dark vision?
Dagger +1.
60 feet in front of me, and I'm gonna continue forward.
Oh well, I decide if it can see in front of you, boy.
So can it be dark like Zoro from One Piece and just wield 3 daggers? One in my mouth?
Absolutely not, no.
I know.
Okay.
Imagine.
So as Luke presses forward, all of these walls, I guess I'll paint it, because I couldn't necessarily do it.
Wait, how much money was it again? 10 silver?
Yeah.
Okay.
All of these walls are covered in stone rubble.
Would that be a hand crossbow under items?
Let me check. Yes, that would be a hand crossbow.
You would see anything in the cave?
As you are entering it, with your dark vision, because you guys don't have any real light source, the light from the entrance is kind of fading, you see some stone columns. You don't really see anything that looks out of place, but to your west, north, and east of you are all walls of rubble. With slight breezes coming. Okay. So
because I'm still bitter at Luke, I'm gonna touch him on the helmet and cast light on it.
Okay. I don't have a helmet. I'm not wearing anything.
He can cast it on your head still.
I'm gonna cast it on your head.
Okay, so...
Actually, I walk around in front of him, and I kind of like get up on his chest. I didn't shove him last time because he was a little bit strong, but I get up in his face, and I'm like, there will be no more murdering in my presence. And tap him on the nose, and I cast it right on his nose.
Okay.
I got a blinding light in front of him.
I will roll a dex save. I will roll a fucking dex save.
That's not how it works. That spell casts. You can't.
What would a crossbow bolt be in under items?
That should just be under...
Bolts? There's not one. You have to do. I had to do arrows.
Yeah. Oh. Okay. We'll just say it's arrows then. We'll say that works. So Luke's nose is now a lit, and both Simkin and Zombie,
sure?
Or all Simkin
for 1 hour. Unless I take it off.
That's rough. You guys can see clearly into this room now. There's loosely packed stone rubble to the west, east, and north, but there's nothing other significant in this room. It's cold. There's a slight breeze coming from each of the cardinal directions, but the only light source is coming from Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer.
Actually, so it looks like you can do a dex saving throw to avoid the spell.
Simkin, can you?
You can? All right, we'll go ahead and do it.
Let's get a 13 or better. On a dex saving.
14. Oh, now, bitch. I still pull out my torch.
Okay, Simkin. So...
Yeah.
So can Luke pulls out his torch. You guys can still see...
No, I don't have any more heal skills.
This cave extends about 30 feet up. You guys do have... You can just see the entrance towards your backs, but beyond the piles of rubble, you don't really see much.
Do I see a place where I can put down the torch?
Yeah, you could go ahead and kind of set it up against this pillar. This pillar is about 5 feet, but you can gather some rubble and kind of make a rigged sconce.
I would like to pull some rocks out of the north.
Okay, so...
I'm AFK.
Okay, that's fine. Go ahead and make an athletics check.
8. Wow. 8. What the fuck?
So you go and try to pull one of the rocks out, but you find that even for a barbarian as strong as you, these rocks are tightly packed, and without someone stronger or a stronger force,
so
per se...
I go up to where he's at, and I'm like...
Roll a fucking roll.
Let me show you how it's done.
Okay, go ahead. Better roll a fucking one. That's strength save.
Yeah, that's strength save.
I'll give athletics.
I'll intervene. It's athletics, yeah. Go ahead and do athletics.
5.
Oh my
fucking
god.
What are you guys trying to do?
So, as Simkin walks up with much bravado towards Luke, he leans over and tries to heave one of the stones himself. You hear a slight crack in Simkin's back as none of the rocks budge at all.
Okay.
I want to try what they're doing.
I'm gonna take out the crowbar from my backpack, okay. And I'm going to make an attempt.
Okay, so go ahead and... Are you proficient with that crowbar?
I don't think so.
Okay, then just go ahead and roll... We'll roll athletics with advantage. So roll your athletics twice, taking the higher of the two. By the way, the light is fading, by the way. You guys are assuming it's about 1 p.m. at this point, but you're all...
Oh, wow.
Oh, Lord. You're all decently exhausted from this battle.
Is there any way that I could just rock so hard on my leg that they also...
Roll performance. So, Azani looks at the other two and rolls her eyes and whips out her crowbar and tries to pry one of the rocks out, finding no purchase at all as the crowbar scrapes against the rocks and Azani actually falls backwards from trying to pull so hard.
Let's try again after myself.
Do I get an advantage for my 6?
No, you don't. It's just performance. What did Luke say?
I don't do it again.
We're going to play this is that once you've done a check on something, you can't do the same check again. Because then that would just let you spam it and spam it and spam it until you got it.
Can I do like a history check on the area and like the stonework to know? Like,
Sure. So first, Marcello, so you're rocking out on your loot. Everybody feels a little bit more well, a little bit more energized. Not much, because you guys just went through quite the battle. But the sound waves reverberate off the rocks with no real effect. And then you wanted to do a history, so that's for stone cutting. So is that +4, or is it an advantage?
So I get proficient in history skills, so I add double your proficient bonus to the check, so I get to add 4.
Okay.
So 20.
Okay. So this cave seems...
Speak to me, stones!
This cave seems natural to you. It doesn't seem like it was actually carved out. This seems like a very natural cave with stalactites and stalagmites around. You do see over in this direction, some claw marks that disappear behind the rubble.
Do they look wolfy? Wolf-like?
Make an investigation roll. So, you don't necessarily recognize the origin of these claw marks, but having seen claw marks before, you know they do not belong to a werewolf, per se.
They do not?
No.
How large are they? Are they, like, cat-like or fearsomely huge?
They're decently large. They're larger than a werewolf, but again, you can't really place it.
Do I see him investigating those claw marks?
Yeah, you do.
Can I try to figure out where they're from?
Sure.
What would that be?
So for you, let's say that's nature, because you've already, that's kind of your shtick. So you know beasts and whatnot a little better. So go ahead and roll a nature check. Oh, look at you.
Woo!
So, having gone over and looked at the claw marks, you can tell that these claw marks belong to a cockatrice, which...
You fucking kidding?
I will find a description for.
A cockatrice?
Yes.
I know, that is from The Witcher.
Those things.
Oh my god.
Yeah, so it's a very monstrous beast with the head of a chicken. It has wings. It's almost like a dragon, but more like if dragons evolved from chickens.
Like a wyvern.
Does anyone have
Draconid
oil?
Draconid oil?
So, if you guys wanted to, you could also use this area. Yeah. It seems secure enough for you to take a short rest if you would like to.
I'll link the cockatrice on the on-topic.
Okay.
There's a better looking one. I should get the one from Witcher. Wither 3. Alright, fucker. Learn his type.
Yeah. As I've said, you guys could go ahead and use this area to take a short or a long rest in case you wanted to get back your spells or do that. Like, this area seems secure enough to you.
I'll take a long rest. I trust you guys.
Yeah, I need some spells.
Shouldn't we do one person on duty every couple hours?
It's up to for you guys to decide.
Yeah, I'd say we rotate every 2 hours or so.
Okay.
All right.
So the way long rest works is that you have to sleep a total of 8 hours, but you can spend a maximum of 2 of those hours being on guard, and then sleep the other 6. So you guys decide how you want to rotate the watch.
Before we do that, I want to cast Unseen Servant.
Okay.
So that while we're resting, I'm going to try to have him knock down the wall.
Okay.
Yeah, just kind of like pick at stones and try to open it up.
Okay. With a strength of 2 and an hour of work time, he might be able to get a little bit done, but not too much.
Yeah, that's fine.
Okay. So do you guys want to go ahead and enter a long rest?
Who's got first watch? Yep.
Wait, but first, who has the lowest health?
That would be you.
Oh shit, alright, I'm and sleeping. Pip. I'm sleeping.
I'm full cool health, so I could take first. As well.
I'll take second.
That's fine. I'll take first.
Okay, everybody literally just said, I'll take first. So
yeah.
I said second. I said second.
Okay, so just go ahead and type out in chat the watch order.
Fine.
That makes it a little easier. 2. Okay, that covers the entirety of the long rest.
What?
So, Marcelo, as everybody starts to fall asleep and you start the watch, you feel a little bit spooked out being in an environment you don't recognize, so you play a gentle song on your lute to yourself, but the 2 hours pass by uneventfully, and you go over and you nudge Simkin to notify him it's his turn to watch. Marcelo goes to sleep, and Simkin starts to watch all the corners, kind of shifting around, watching his own shadow dance off of the torch that Luke had placed earlier. Simkin, go ahead and make a perception roll.
Do I just put my health back up to 8 since I'm
yeah.
not
yet?
All right.
Oh god.
I would say not yet, because this hasn't been full rest yet.
Okay. Yeah, we'll wait, I suppose.
I put it up by 2.
5. Marcella. So as you're watching around the cave and looking for anything that might seem out of order, all you hear are the sounds of your own footsteps echoing against the cave roof and the rubble walls. Your 2 hours have elapsed, and you go ahead and you nudge Luke. Luke groggily raises himself and wipes off his eyes as Simkin lays down, and Luke starts his watch. Luke, go ahead and make a perception check as well.
Not even bad.
So, you are shifting around, but all you can hear is the clank of your battle axe scraping against the floor and it reverberating against the ceiling of the cave and against the rubble walls. Your 2 hours have elapsed now, and you go over and you nudge Azani by gently shaking her on the shoulder, and she gets up groggily as you lay down and Azani starts her watch. Azani, go ahead and make a perception roll.
To be good, please.
It's a 20.
Oh. Okay, so as you're shifting around and hearing your footsteps echo off of all of the cave surfaces, you hear shifting in the dirt beyond this rubble wall, and as you try to strain closer, you can't really hear anything beyond a little bit of movement, but after about 5 minutes, the movement stops and the rest of your watch passes uneventfully. So if everyone has not already done so, bring your health up to full and give yourself all your spells.
Oh, I can use my dagger now.
Which I will use.
Did we gain any experience for killing those?
You did, and that's what I was absolutely about to get into next.
Wait.
So.
Deal.
And this is a good point for a small intermission, because all of you have gained enough.
Beep, beep, beep.
Beep.
Okay. So all of you have gained enough experience to level up. You have all gained 400.
What?
No. 525 experience.
Total?
Like level 3? Yeah.
So each person gains 525.
So I have 550 experience points then.
How much is it from one level to another?
So from 1 to 2 is 300, 2 to 3 is 900, and beyond that, I don't remember, because I didn't think you'd get that far today.
Alright, so how do we do this now?
So go ahead and look at what your class gets at level 2, and when you level up, you get to increase 2 of your abilities, like your stats rather, your intelligence, charisma, wisdom, and whatnot, by 1, or 1 stat by 2.
Okay, so...
And then, additionally, everybody will roll their hit die and add that amount to your total health pool, so Luke gains 9 health total.
So I get cunning action.
So just add, if that's something specific, add it in your traits. Just make a note of it yourself. And so then, I believe Azani will also get her animal form.
Yes. I will.
So you can become you can become a squirrel. You have seen a squirrel so far.
Okay.
Exciting.
You're a squirrel.
You're a squirrel. I'm a parrot.
Action.
Now, are you guys doing your normal macros by clicking on the character sheet?
Yeah, we're clicking on the character sheet. Because
you can take.
We're lazy.
You can take a bonus action on each of your turns in combat. This action can be used only to take the dash, disengage, or hide action.
Okay.
Well, I was gonna start.
I get one in addition to this for being a Holdor.
Okay, so you... Wow, everybody's getting a lot of health.
Alright, so what? How much health do I get? I don't know.
Roll your hit die.
Oh. Hit die... Where's the hit die again?
What class are you?
Rogue, yeah.
It's below the hit points.
I think it's 1d8, I think.
Oh, hit dice, I see it.
So it's what now?
Alright, 4. So I get 12.
One second.
You add your constitution to it.
Oh, so...
So plus two or whatever your constitution.
Okay, and then Marcello is going to take just five for his health. He's not going to roll 1d8. You can roll the 1d8 or take the five, which he just told me about, which I just learned. Okay, and then everybody add in new abilities or make note of that. And then I think the spellcasters get one more cantrip and possibly one more spell slot.
I don't get a cantrip.
I have to look again.
I get one extra first level spell slot.
Okay.
And then I think I get...
So just go ahead and raise your spell slot by one if you get that. I'm going to take like 5 minutes and go have a snack real quick while we're figuring this all out.
Sounds good.
And then make sure, so bring yourselves up to level 2, and then everybody but Azani had 25 before, so you now, you guys would be up to 250, and Azani is at 225. For experience. So.
Are we at 550?
No. We're just going to, the way we do it is we're going to take the 300, so you guys got 525, so we're going to take that 300 out of it, bring yourself up to level 2, and then give yourself, everybody will be at 250 except Azani, who will be at 225.
Alright, so does anything happen with my stats besides my health? Because I don't...
Yeah, you can increase two of your stats by one or one of your stats by two.
Oh. So, like, I can give myself 17 dexterity?
Yeah, if you want to. If it's at, 15, yeah.
No, it's at 16 right now. Oh, so 18 dexterity.
Yep.
Okay.
Hey, if you want to. But then 18 is the cap for... that until you hit like some level, which I'm not sure on.
24.
Because 18 is the cap for normal people.
All right, so constitution. Ooh, let's see if I give my constitution.
I'm gonna
12.
Go have my snack while you guys get this figured out.
Okay. All right, okay. I give my.
I have ninja sense now, which is great. Best passive NA.
Oh, I know what it is. Yeah, you can go ahead and mark that in your character. So that
would be. Oh, shit! All right. Fuck it. I'll give myself 18 dexterity. Whatever.
I'm back.
Welcome, Black.
Have I missed anything particularly important?
Oh, we're leveling up.
Yeah, we're level 2 now.
Oh.
Not you, Pip.
No, yes, you for the fight.
Yeah, you went unconscious, you fag.
No, but I got healed. I got healed, though, before the fight ended.
No, yeah, you're low now.
We took a long rest as well.
So how much XP are we at now? 50?
250. Okay. 250 level 2.
Alright.
Okay, so cunning action says I can take a bonus action on each of my turns. So every turn I can have a bonus action?
Yep.
Nice.
You can you can use your bonus action to do.
Alright, I need to write this down so I remember this.
Where do you find this?
Huh? Oh, yeah, just open up the... What are we call? What are we calling the book now?
The compendium? Book, I think.
It's the book.
The book, okay. Look at it in the book. You fucking nerd. Who the fuck plays D&D anyways? Us.
You.
Classes.
Yeah, next thing you know, Coast is gonna start a LARP guild.
First, guys to meet up. That's RP guild.
Bulby's gonna come in and be like, faggot! Lightning bolt.
Lightning bolt.
Faggot bolt!
Lightning bolt. Lightning. I have a new spell, so maybe
I got 10
I
health
can make
now.
Banjo happy and I can learn a lightning bolt. Let's see.
Do it.
Pip, do you have a constitution modifier?
No.
Ah, right.
Oh, wait.
I do!
Like, that's the big number, right, in the main box?
Okay, so what's your... Yes. How much health did you get, Pip?
I got 2 in addition to my Layari 8.
What the fuck, dude?
Just 2?
2 plus constitution modifier.
I don't
know. Have a constitution.
He doesn't have one.
RIP.
Wow.
So, okay.
You guys are class.
Yeah, you guys are fucked.
I got
Wait, how much do you have, dude?
I got 4, dude. I got 12 right now.
24
HP. 19.
24.
No, he's BP.
I did start out with like 15 HP.
Studded leather vagina.
Do I link that? Or is it just spells only?
My dick in the owl!
Cunning action now.
Cunning linguist.
Fick.
Shit.
Wrong button.
Did everybody figure out spells and whatnot?
Yeah. I'm sad.
Oh, my audio is not on. I'm a genius.
Can we multi-class? I'm kidding.
Now I can hear stuff. Okay.
Yeah, multi-class. This ain't Guild Wars 1. Fucker.
There is an option to multi-class.
Yeah, there's an option.
Oh, there is?
Yeah. You guys have like a minimum of 13 of a specific thing.
Okay, did everybody add their health now? Seems so.
Pip only got 2.
I saw that.
The one shot, shame.
Are people still AFK?
I'm still figuring it out.
Oh, okay, that's fine.
Yeah, doing a few things.
So I gave myself 18 dexterity.
Okay.
Alright, I want to see how much the attack is with the dexterity. If I get a good roll.
I have 20 strength, by the way.
I said 18 was the cap.
Then I would have hit 19.
I said 18 was the cap. If you had 19 before, assign it into something else.
Wait, how do you assign things for leveling up?
So you just literally just change your stats to whatever.
Oh, it's back down to 19. Great.
So well, we be at 18 add
and then reassign the point to something else.
We add 1 to 2 and then we can also add 2 to 1.
You're not getting any advantage from 19 to 18 anyway. It's still
so possible. Like how much stats can I apply?
You can put 1 point into 2 stats or 2 points into 1 without it exceeding 18.
So if I
think I'll put a
will my HP increase from being a barbarian from increase my constitution now? Since it increases by 2.
If I put some into constitution, would I be able to get a constitution bonus with my RE, like 2 health gain?
Not if with I the one you already threshold? Did, no.
Okay, like, because I haven't applied these stats yet, but I already did the health thing. Like, I was not sure how to do this.
Yeah, we'll say you can. Actually, I take that back. We'll say you can roll the health again because yours was pretty bad.
Oh, okay.
Can I roll mine again? No.
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 Oh.
I mean, if you could, if you do, and you get something lower, then okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Wow. What have 31 HP.
Oh.
Ooh, that's pretty good.
Oh, hold on. I may have fucked this whole thing up.
I'm gonna change it.
Hold on. Hold on. Hold on. Amazing. Oh, so I read it wrong. So some of the features of classes and let you increase 2 scores by 1 or increase 1 score by 2.
Oh.
Whoops.
Yeah, I was not gonna say anything about.
I read that wrong, and the
okay,
cap.
Okay, so what do we do?
The cap is 20, not 18.
But I also so you're not supposed to get those until like your.
Yeah,
it's different for every
level.
Class.
Oh, that's so
sure. Oh. What?
Yeah, I read that earlier, so I was confused a little.
Yeah, that's my bad.
4.
Oh yeah, you get 2 proficiency bonuses at.
Wait. So we don't increase our...
You do not increase your stats, no. You just unlock what you unlocked. And proficiency bonus stays the same unless it says so otherwise.
Okay, so I'll just take that constitution thing off, so it'll be plus 7.
And for everyone, when your constitution modifier increases by 1, your hit point maximum increases by 1 for each level you have obtained. So if you're a 7th level fighter and you have a constitution score of 17... When you reach the 8th level, if you increase your constitution score from 17 to 18, that increases the modifier from 3 to 4, so your hit point maximum would increase by 8. So do you understand it? So if you increase your constitution modifier, your health would go up by the level you just obtained.
Retroactive.
Okay. And to increase those, it's the ability score improvement feature for leveling up?
Yeah, so but it should say you get that at a certain level.
Yeah, at level 4.
Okay, yeah. So everybody take back the stats that you assigned. That was my bad, I read that wrong.
Even the health?
No, we're just
doing
that
again? The health.
No, you get the health.
Okay, so...
I'll still give Dalaran a reroll on his health, because it was pretty bad.
Okay, so I'll take the 7, and just not add the 1 modifier. Because I got that stat.
Cool, I'm ready. I'm done!
I think I'm good.
Who is not settled?
I think I'm good too.
I'm a fucking barbarian.
Okay, well,
it's the simplest class.
Marcello is not settled.
I'm just watching Critical Role while playing D&D, while they play D&D.
Yeah. Yeah. It's in your class. You probably don't get it at level 2. No, you just get Jack of Trades and Song of Rest. Oh, so tell me. It says features right here on the table for levels.
Okay, but did you pick your new spells? Right. And is everybody aware that, I believe this is for all spellcasters, you can gain a new spell if your level up says you do, but also when everybody levels up, you can take a spell you already know and replace it with another one from the same level. So if anyone wants to change out spells, go ahead and do that.
Good.
So just go ahead and put an X in the chat if you're fully settled.
People.
I'm putting Medica nail.
So
oh, that was pretty good. Alright.
Is Felfiz ready?
No.
Okay. I just wanted to check.
HD all doing.
Oh, someone does a hit die, they get 20.
It, laugh. No, your hit die is a 1d8 usually.
Oh, it's an 8? Okay.
Mine's d12 since I'm a barbarian.
You can shove this barbarian cock in ya, you twat. Oh shit.
Kind of hot.
Mysterious music.
Oh, wow, this game looks really good.
What game?
The Skyrim Remaster. People's faces still look messed up, but now they're messed up in high quality.
Okay, so we're waiting on Felfiz, and then after that we'll be ready.
So I had a question, maybe you knew the answer.
Go ahead and lay it down.
Okay, so as a warlock,
mm-hmm.
I get... the fucking loud people outside. I get Eldritch Invocations.
Mm-hmm.
So those are passive at all times, right? They should be?
Yes.
So I took Agonizing Blast, which adds my Charisma modifier to Eldritch Blast.
Mm-hmm.
And then I took... yeah, and then I took Eyes of the Runekeeper, and that allows me to read any language.
Okay. Do you get two?
Yeah, two at level one.
Okay. Yep, so just mark that that reading one, mark that on your sheet somewhere.
Okay, yeah.
Blau, keep in mind about my danger sense.
Boy. Yep, I know. I got it.
Good.
However, the caveat with danger sense is that it's something you can see. It's not really like a perception type thing. It's more of a spidey sense type thing. Like a moment to react. Not like a I sense foreboding things ahead. So if there's a trap or somebody casts a spell on you, you get dexterity saving throws.
I put a spell on you.
Yeah, fuck your light bullshit.
And you also have a reckless attack you can do.
Yeah, I know.
You're a murdering barbarian.
There's no time for this diplomacy.
Aren't you like a lawful good?
No, hell no.
What are you?
He's neutral.
He sounds pretty chaotic. What is he?
Oh yeah, I remember he like neutral. Murdered.
He always
neutral.
Has
I can
people.
Do both actually.
All right, are we all settled then?
Yep. I don't trust him anymore. Luke ain't
yeah,
getting
you
no
can
healing.
Just go ahead.
Okay,
because I'm a fucking healer.
I don't have much time. Much more time.
That's
yeah,
fine.
I need to go pretty soon.
Yep. So it's up to you guys where you want to take it from here. you've got the rubble in front of you all. It's about 9 p.m. now.
P.M.?
Yeah, you guys took an 8-hour rest.
Oh.
It was about 12:31 when you came into the room, or the cave. So, as stated before, the ceiling is about 30-ish feet in height, with a slight breeze coming from behind each one of the rubble walls.
Well, let me put on my sweater.
Okay.
Hold on.
Is there any way I can convince the wall to fall down?
You can convince it with your hands and some pulling.
I'm gonna let the others do.
Can I use my smith's tools on them?
Let me pull that up.
Oh. I do have mason's tools.
Yeah, smith tools would be no. Mason's tools would work.
That
and
sounds...
I have
can I start?
Well, I have a hammer. Would I be able to hammer them?
You, yeah, you could try it.
Yeah, let's get hammered. Cunt.
Or could I give someone else my hammer to do the, work for me?
Yeah, but then you run the risk of them keeping your hammer.
I have a war hammer. Why don't I just swing?
Okay, yeah, that works better. I just have a little hammer in my burger. Side.
Can I just straight up use a
hammer? There were some noises on the sprite wall last night, so. Yeah. Maybe we should break that one instead of the north one.
That would be this one.
Can I swing an attack at it?
Yep, so go ahead and roll an attack and roll the damage with it. Well, it will, but.
I'm gonna put my shield away, and I'm gonna do this two-hand.
I'm gonna put my dick in the owl!
Fucking do it.
Crit damage. 10.
So as you swing your warhammer mightily, this wall crumbles down, and the light from the torch behind you reveals... Oh, damn it.
Wow. Hold on, is that 60 feet?
It reveals...
More.
Four giant bats. Bum, bum, bum.
And a cockatrice. No, I'm kidding. Imagine.
So.
Bonus sort of.
It's up to you guys whether you want to do this combat now or save it for another time.
Doesn't matter to me.
Should we do it Sunday?
That Sunday one doesn't work.
Can't do it.
Well, it's up to you guys. Do you think you can kill all these things now or not?
Oh, please. Can I do like a nature check on them to see like maybe if they're vulnerable to any particular type of...
Sure, go ahead and do that.
How terrible they look. Is it nature?
Also want to watch Critical Role, so...
Oh, look at that.
Okay, so you know that these are specifically giant bats. They are... let's see. They are vulnerable to fire, have resistance to cold, and complete immunity to lightning and thunder. And since they are bats, they might be a little bit... at a disadvantage should you deafen them somehow.
Deafen them?
We need our bard.
Sing
them a
song. Yeah, sing us a song.
Excuse me.
Sing us a song, Mr. Piano Man. Oh, play us a song. Fuck.
Yeah, I'll do whatever. I mean, I'll just shred as much as I can.
Well, are we gonna do it right now or are we gonna do it like next week?
Yeah, we're gonna roll initiative. Or...
Let's do it now. Let's do it. This won't take
do
long.
This, maybe do this combat and then.
Okay. Yeah. Everybody, go ahead and roll initiative. After, wait, now roll.
Watch me for the love of God.
Yes!
Please.
Oh, fuck. I'll take that.
What the fuck, 22, nigga? Oh, shit.
Dude, we roll good. Well, besides the lawful good cleric.
Okay.
Haha.
No, egg rolls just didn't go on the board.
Looks like I'm doing all the work. All right.
And I'm just going to do them.
Put Ponzi schemes in there.
Yeah, watch one bat get like 30. I'm like, oh no.
I'm just going to do them together.
4, 10, 6, 13.
was
22.
22. Moving up in the world.
Damn, dude. The not so retarded Ponzi is. No, the retarded Ponzi is not so retarded. Fuck. Wow.
Hold on, I gotta make sure all these tokens are assigned to their proper. 3, 1.
But Medeca Noel.
Cool.
You get an owl.
So, this guy is 4. This guy. Oops. This guy is 10. This guy is 6. I'll edit you, fuckwad. 6. This guy is 13. Okay, so that brings us to the top of the round with Ponzi Scheme.
Alright. I'll whip out one dagger and the plus one dagger on me right hand.
Okay. Did you account that in your inventory and everything?
Yeah, it's all in there.
Cool.
Alright, and I run towards the first bat.
Okay.
Do I need to pass? Do I need to do an acrobatics thing or anything?
Let me see where you are. Oh,
I'm off like back here.
Yeah, you. This is a solid wall right here.
Yeah.
You would have to
run around,
jump, or shove Mike. Through everyone. Like Pip, you do. Mike. You don't even have that kind of. Oh.
Oh yeah.
Robot.
Oh, that's a Pip.
Oh yeah. What?
Oh.
You. Right. You don't even have that kind of movement to get away with that.
Goddamn.
Yeah.
Whoa, all right. So.
You can certainly move.
Let me see. I guess I can move here from behind Dalrin then. Ah. Shit, I don't know what to do.
Yeah. You can just go ahead and end your turn there.
Yeah, I'm just gonna hit there. For okay. Now.
That brings us to Dalrin.
Well, I can't really do much either, so.
You could attempt.
Was it?
Yeah, you could attempt to squeeze an arrow through, but it would be awfully hard.
So wasn't Marcel, like, this. Really far back?
Marcel? I don't know if he moved or not. I didn't see. I was literally not looking at all.
Marcel, where were you originally?
Well, say he was with you. You know full well where you were.
I have no idea.
But we'll say you went with the group in order to sleep.
Yo, where is Marcellus Wallace?
Because I'm pretty sure that was blocked off and he wasn't there.
If we're saying, yeah, like, we'll say he was in this vague vicinity because he had to sleep with you guys. Yeah, he was definitely not past the rubble wall before it started.
Yeah.
Okay, I'll try and squeeze past Zanny and Simukin.
Okay, so go ahead and roll acrobatics.
That's
19, so you managed to squeeze past them quite easily.
Okay, and then is this solid here?
This is just a harder stone on the floor.
Okay, so I'm gonna move over here so that there's room, like, for them to get through, and I'm going to take out my crossbow and fire at the bat in the front.
Okay, go ahead and roll it. 10. So, you shoot your crossbow, and unfortunately the bolt just flies over past all of them and sticks itself into an area over here.
And wakes the cockatrice. Oh god.
And that'll be the end of my turn.
Okay. Azani.
Oh wait. Or never mind. Too late.
Okay, yeah. Should I roll acrobatic skip past?
Yes, you should.
Can you please move out of the way?
Working on it.
Simikin's the last to go and he's in the way.
You're also in the way too.
No, I moved over.
Okay, so...
No, you're right there in the middle.
No, I'm not.
Yeah, you managed... You don't do anything fancy, but you managed to squeeze by him.
Are you not this person right here?
I am not right there.
What?
And then I'm going to set you... I'm going to make your character settings for something specific. Because sometimes I will tell you to roll advantage or disadvantage. Okay. Alright. Now what do you want to do?
Pip, can you ping where your location is?
I'm directly like one square south of there. How do I ping?
You hold down left click.
There we go. You're good.
Da 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 da.
Okay, I'm gonna move over here and I'm going to use produce flame.
Ooh.
Do I have advantage or anything? Just normal.
If you have that produce flame in your speed, go or in your spellbook, go ahead and hold on. So you would go to spells. And then under produce flame, link it first, like hit the cog next to it in your, and then switch it to spell card, uncog, click it, and then switch it to attack, so that way I can like read what it does, and then you roll the attack. So do you see output where it says attack currently?
Yes.
It's,
okay, so click on attack. And then change it to spell card, uncog, okay. Click it real quick, and it'll link it, and then do it as an attack.
If it's a weakness, they would do double damage.
Does it take two turns to prepare this and then cast it? Can I do that in one?
Conjuration.
What you about produce flame?
It's one action.
It says one action.
Yeah, so you could go ahead and do it immediately. Yeah, and also only one person knows that it is weak to fire.
That's yeah. Cool. Well, never mind then. I will.
Yo, niggas, these
look
like
fire.
Oh, Jesus.
Well, now fuck. I suppose everybody knows.
Oh, it's a good thing. I just burned a fire spell.
I'm gonna use two-handed axe.
Okay.
Oh.
11 and 7.
Okay, so you hit this bat. Kind of in the torso, dealing 7 points of slashing damage as it lets out a horrifying screech. And then it flutters about wildly. Does that end your turn?
Yeah.
Okay, this brings us to Luke.
I will go right here.
Okay.
Hold on. Is that five?
Yep, five. Yep, you'd be good.
There, I would like to rage, and I would like to use Reckless Attack.
Okay, so go ahead and roll that attack with advantage.
Oh. Okay. I'll take that 18. And
I bet you will.
Is that a 24? Yeah, 24.
Yeah, that's to... Wait. You didn't roll the damage yet, though. It hits, but roll the damage.
Yeah. Wow. Hey, fucking kidding me. Stupid.
Okay. So, you smack this bat right in the head, and it kind of flutters down to the floor before getting up after a brief moment. And that brings us to Felfiz. Also, link from your character sheet if you can, so that way I can see it. Why not?
It's not a spell card.
Yeah, but you can link an attack.
Being the normal attack.
Mm. Yeah. It says what type of damage it does, which helps me. See, Ashini rolled an attack and it says slashing damage. She set up a macro to do it, but everybody else is doing it from sheets.
Wow, you fucking kidding me.
Anyway, so this is Felfiz now.
Well, I had a great plan, but it's gone the way, so I'll just skip my turn. I have nothing to do.
So you can hold your action and wait till someone else goes and then take your action if you would like. So you could hold your action.
That wouldn't quite work either.
You could hold your action until Simkin goes and then choose to move then.
Yeah, but you can't use a movement if you hold it. You have to dash or use your beam, whatever.
He could hit them from where he is. Well, he would hit Azani, but...
Yeah. DM question.
Yes, sir.
No, actually, Oh, but the bats really moved.
Except it's your call to make.
So if I'm going to try to get past Simkin, what do I have to roll for that?
That would be acrobatics.
Acrobatics. Let's try it. Okay.
Go for it.
Go right there, right here. Down.
I don't have that kind of movement, so I'm just going to try to get past him and then get up.
Okay.
That should be 25.
And then go ahead and roll acrobatics.
Okay, let's see.
Or you get fucked.
Oh, thank God.
Okay, so you managed to kind of push around and jump in between everybody standing in your way. What action would you like to do?
Okay, I would like to cast... Where is it? Burning Hands. Except I need to change it to a spell card. There we go.
Okay.
So that would be... 15 feet cone. And I will roll the attack.
Okay. So they are. Yeah, that's all of them. They are going to attempt to make dexterity saving throws. I'm rolling. I'm not looking at it as I roll, so just FYI.
19. 5. Two make saves. One didn't.
Okay.
Two make saves. Two didn't.
So, let's see. Oh, I labeled them all as giant bat. That's fantastic. I have their names written differently, but it didn't label it as such. That's fine. So let's see.
Just do 1d4 and roll which one gets
giant
it.
Bat. No, I shall handle this. Two. Okay, so this bat and this bat will be taking 4 damage, and the other two will take the full 8. So as you spread your thumbs apart and the flame starts to arc, you extend your hands outward and cast this cone of fire out towards them, all the bats screeching. Yeah, I'm aware.
They're vulnerable too, aren't they?
Yes, they are. I'm aware. I know what I'm doing. So this bat is dead. This bat... is looking a bit cripsy.
What the fuck?
This bat is singed a slight bit along with this bat. So you guys have defeated that cone, took out this this bat entirely. I'll use this. This is a bit better of a death notification. It's not as bulky. Okay, does that end your turn?
Yes.
Okay, we are on to giant bat number 4, who is dead. So we move on to Marcelo. Yeah, this here, no, you would still have to squeeze.
You call me fat.
No. Alright, go ahead and roll. Sure is.
Nine.
So with difficulty, you just managed to squeeze through.
God damn it, Pickles.
What?
You fat dwarf.
I turned this and it's either me or you. Turn around. Then I grab out my loop, and then I start kind of shredding a little bit, kind of getting some high-pitched noises up in her.
Okay, so go ahead and roll performance with advantage, because your sound waves are echoing off of the cave walls and kind of magnifying the decibel level of the of your hot licks.
Wow. Great.
10. So the bats seem a little bothered by this, but not enough to really impair their hearing.
Well, after that, I'm going to take my bonus action and inspire Azani with just a light little melody. Something comforting.
We'll go ahead and inspire her, boy.
With my lute.
Well, go ahead and... What lute noises are you making? I don't hear any.
That's lightning melody.
Yeah, alright. Fuck me, dude. Give me a second.
Do you want me to make some lute noises for you?
Please, help me.
Alright. So, Marcello looks to Azani and busts out his lute and gives a little. It is now! While the funk moves Azani, so she gets 1d6 on her next attack roll or ability check. That is so hard to do, you have no idea. It's so hard.
I guess I should more power to the player.
That ends your turn! Taking us to giant bat number 2, being pretty black and smelling slightly delicious to Felfiz, he's going to attempt to move forward and attack.
It's racist. And...
So as after Felfiz had casted his fire, the bat, who's still slightly smoldering in places, scratches out with his talons, and Felfiz takes 4 points of piercing damage.
Okay, there's a spell I can cast.
As a reaction?
Yes.
Okay.
It's, yeah, okay. It's not in spell card. Here you go. It is this one.
Oh.
Oh, nice.
Okay, so I'm gonna roll that.
12, okay. So it's going to attempt to make its saving throw. Oh!
20!
So,
what the?
After the bat attacks you, you cast your Hellish Rebuke upon it. It screeches back and takes 6 points, which actually does drop it. This bat in front of Felfiz is now dead.
And I took 4 points.
Took 4
right?
points of piercing damage, yes.
Okay.
It hurt itself in its confusion.
So this moves us on to giant bat number 3.
Simkin Penis Beard. Come on, dude.
Giant bat number 3 is the back one. So this bat is going to go ahead and use its fly movement, which is a lot, and it's going to fly all the way over to Marcello, being bothered by his, instead of sweet soft melody, funky hot fresh licks.
And are you going to attack an opportunity?
It's flying, so I'm going to say no.
And do a disadvantage?
It's flying, so I'm going to say no.
I'm going to try and hit an aerial fucking target.
With my axe.
Yeah, my axe.
That's melee to death.
It's like a ranged weapon.
A ranged axe.
Just chuck it.
I do have to.
What's your AC? 13? Okay, so it attempts to scratch out and strike Marcello with its talons, but fails to do so as it flies back a little bit, even some more so farther. And this takes us to giant bat number 1, who is going to... what's he gonna do? He's going to go ahead and notice that Luke striked one of its comrades down, and it's going to make an attack against Luke.
Which it does, so you take 2 points of piercing damage as it reaches out and scratches across Luke's shoulder with its talons. Alright, and that brings us to the root of all evil in Simkin Thunderbeard.
Who now has to watch him fail the acrobatics he gets through.
He was the one that caused it.
So, have either of these been hit?
Have which ones?
Either of these two living ones been hit yet?
Yes.
Yes, both of them have.
Both of them taking the... Oh, yeah, from, yep.
Yes. They're both still looking decently flighty.
The one the back got hit?
Yeah. Felfis hit everything with his cone.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
Okay, I'll attack the one in the back.
With?
With the Sacred Flame.
Okay.
I gotta roll a dexterity save.
So, if you do that... Oh, it descends. Okay, that's fine. Okay. And the DC is 13. So you have selected Giant Bat 3. So seeing this pillar of fire start to spawn above it, it's going to try and dodge quickly out of the way.
Oh.
And it does. So it dodges and gets out of the way, but it still manages to clip the bat right in the wing. This bat is looking, it's now smoking, it's smoldering. It's looking pretty ripe for eating if you were into eating bats.
That's how you get AIDS, I think.
Yeah, that's one way.
Ebola, that's right. It's Ebola.
Does that end your turn?
Yeah, I'm done.
Okay, and we are on to Ponzi Scheme.
Alright, since I'm in the back here, I'm gonna do something really stupid.
Where do you go if you shoot me?
I'm gonna try and jump over everyone.
Okay, you are going to roll two acrobatics checks, both with disadvantage.
Alright, acrobatics. Alright, wish me luck.
Disadvantage.
Wait, where the fuck is acrobatics? I just lost it. Oh, there it is.
Maybe right, at the top of the list.
Right?
Yep, two of them.
One.
Wow. Oh my god!
Wow.
Disadvantage. One. Two.
Okay. Two. So, as you attempt to leap over your comrades, you kind of land a little bit on top of Marcello. So Marcello, you take
teabag him.
1 point of bludgeoning damage as Ponzi kind of stumbles over you, but manages to get to his position.
Like, sorry, mate.
You aren't entirely sure, but something squishy leans you towards a yes. Okay, and what do you want to do now?
I wonder if I can do anything.
That's your movement, so...
Still a movement?
I think you were, like, right here at the start?
Right over here.
So that's 1, 2, 3, 4. You could still move 2 squares.
Do I do another acrobatics and move past the Shiny?
Yo! At an angle.
You could get her. You could get the bat at an angle. And that's a Zani, by the way.
Wait, oh, the one in front of Azani?
You could get her. You could get the bat at this angle.
Alright. Alright, with my two daggers, apparently. Alright, so I move over here.
Okay.
Let me point it towards. And, I thrust both my daggers towards it.
Okay, go ahead and roll those attacks.
Okay, it's my plus one dagger. Is this disadvantage or no? Just normal?
Nope, it's flat.
Okay. And I'll just choose one dagger. Here we go.
Okay, so your first dagger connects with the bat, striking it across the face, and it rears back, screeching, taking 4 points of piercing damage. Its lips are bloody, but it just looks angrier more than damaged.
Oh, shit.
Does that end your turn?
Yeah, that's it.
Okay, we are up to Dalaran.
Alrighty, to get past Felfis, since he's a gnome, I'm going to like kind of leapfrog over him.
Go ahead.
Leapfrog!
Is that acrobatics?
Don't worry, you're not on the head.
It's absolutely an acrobatics check.
Alright. You're moving over him, you fuck.
Okay. Oh my god. Yeah, so you would land here because you can't really trounce on the dead body of the bat. Okay. But you manage to get over Felfizz. Felfizz catches a whiff of something strange in the air, but is otherwise unharmed.
Wash your ass, you bastard!
Am I able to go here and then use cunning action to hide?
Is cunning action a bonus action?
Yes.
Yes, you certainly could.
Oh wait, I forgot to do my cunning act. Whatever.
So go ahead and roll your stealth.
Okay.
Wonderful. So after leaping over Felfizz, you quickly dodge to the side, hiding yourself against the shadows on the wall.
And now I will attack the bat with my hand crossbow with a sneak attack bonus.
Okay, go ahead and roll it.
Watch it fucking hit one of us. Oh shit! What up?
Okay, so that is more than enough damage to go ahead and take this bat out. So the bat, your bolt pierces through the bat completely and nearly nicks Ponzi scheme as it strikes the wall over here with incredible force, leaving a loud clang, and this bat falls to the ground dead immediately.
You almost hit me!
I was going for this bat.
Oh.
I thought you said that bat was already dead to Ponzi.
Oh yeah, it was. Alright, well, everything that I just said is this bat. It's dead.
So I didn't hit
Ponzi. And it still almost hit Ponzi.
So this bat is not actually dead then yet. This bat, I guess.
Yeah, it should
but this one certainly is dead.
Yo, Zani, help me out. Help. Help a nigger out.
So, the word nigger seems a little lost on a Zani.
What is that saying? Seem mildly offensive.
And then it is, it's Azani's turn.
Zani, help a poor Hume out.
I'm going to go ahead and try to finish it off.
Okay.
Or not.
Hot, hot.
So, Azani wills up her battle axe and strikes down on the bat. Would you like to describe your killing blow?
You want to do this, really?
No.
No, you don't want to. You don't.
I'm not that experienced at this.
That's fine. So you, unnaturally for a druid, you scream and you lift your battle axe high into the air and bring it crashing down, decapitating the bat in twain, intestines spilling everywhere. With a am I still robot?
Yeah.
Okay. So the axe slashes down through the bat, clefting it in twain as a fine mist of blood sprays through the air, and the bat falls to the ground without even having time for a death rattle.
Yeah. Everyone whips their dick out in celebration.
Nature is savage.
And before anyone has time to move.
Like to loot.
Before anyone has time to move. This guy steps forward, and that's where we will call it for the evening.
Oh no.
Yeah, it's a cockatrice.
Chicken!
How many rounds has this been? Like, what, two?
Doesn't look so big.
That was two, yes.
Good. Good to know. Need to know that next week, whenever we next play.
Alright, so, so far, everybody has gained 150 experience from killing the bats. Oh no, I take
so
that back.
So we level up again.
200. No. It's not three. From 1 to 2 is 300 total.
Oh, it's 600.
From 2 to 3 is 900.
Oh,
so
right.
So how much do we get again?
So is that a straight 200?
Yeah, you all get 200 from killing those bats.
I'm halfway to level 3.
So the difference between level 1 and level 2 is 600.
Well, once you hit level 3, you have that... It took 300, or that level 1, it took 300 to get there. Then that sets to 0. Now you need to get 900.
Whoa,
okay.
I think you're supposed to keep the experience that you last had.
Do you keep it in total?
But...
Let me see.
I could be wrong.
It doesn't necessarily say, but you guys... Let's see, you're at 250 before. You gained 200, so you'd be at 450. So even then, nobody would hit level 3.
Alright.
So, yeah. We'll do it so everybody would be at 450.
Except Ashin, she's at 425.
Wrecked!
Didn't get the werewolf fight.
No. All right. Does anybody have any questions, comments, or concerns before we part ways?
What does this cockatoo look like to me?
Cockatoo.
Catrice.
I linked what it, does it look in like the, to on topic.
Who said that?
Me.
Fat ugly dwarf that always gets in the way.
The vision of it is kind of obstructed by everybody else. You can't really get a clear look at it.
Oh, damn. Thing's nasty looking.
Yeah.
No, that's just Marcello.
Oh.
It says in...
Anything from you, fatty.
Are we ending it, or could I make like a nature check or something?
If you want to go ahead and make a nature check, you can do that.
It says it is... I see a person that says it tracks total EXP.
Total?
Yeah, I see.
Whatever the GM said.
True.
Yeah.
19. Okay. So, you do know that this is indeed a cockatrice. And...
With a big cock.
Let me pull it up. It doesn't really have any vulnerabilities or resistances. It's not the most heavily armored, and all it can really do in terms of attacking people is to bite them. But it also has a magic effect in its teeth, so when you are bit, you have a chance of being petrified.
I think glad I'm in the back.
Let's pet it.
So, petrification... you make one saving throw to save yourself from the initial effect. Then after a round, you make another saving throw. And if you don't make either of them, you turn to solid stone for 24 hours.
Okay, right. So I'm going to tell them not to get bit.
And I'm right there. Nice. Oh, wait, I'm not.
You're hidden.
Yes, no, you are hidden.
Oh, shit.
Wait, no, he broke his stealth. He shot.
I broke his stealth.
Yeah.
All right. I'm probably going to stealth. When we start again.
I'll probably cunning action either hide or disengage to just get away.
Okay, so that is where we will take it for tonight. How did you guys enjoy this?
It's good.
Are we meeting again next
Brandon
Thursday?
Said reddit.com.
Yeah, we'll plan on that. Ashimi, how did you like it? This was your first time.
It was pretty good. I was super nervous at the start, though, so I didn't really go into the details very well.
That's okay.
Please.
So, yeah, I would say my tip for everybody for the next week is kind of be open and be
Brandon
creative
said,
with your actions. Like, Pickles using his battle axe against the rock was good thinking.
It was a warhammer piece. I'm not going to dull my battle axe.
The whatever it was, but...
Me running towards the stairs and screaming.
Just be...
yeah,
be frog over the note.
Marcello trying to seduce the rocks with his hot licks.
Me.
Yeah, so
Marcello makes me moist.
Me cock-blocking Pickles.
Yeah. Oh my goodness.
With that,
I was gonna say after my turn, I was gonna say, does diplomacy now apply? Huh? Simkit? Huh?
What? Oh, after you killed the person?
Yeah, after I killed the bat. Does diplomacy now work?
Against a bat? Are you kidding me?
That may or may not have been a bad move. You guys didn't really learn anything off of those people.
Yeah. Yeah, I tried to I actually grappled him and I had him. Try to reason with him, and then Luke came in here and fucked
it
all
up. Yeah, I considered grappling too, but I didn't have any rope.
You actually don't have to have rope to grapple. It just grapple means like
it's time you want to do it now,
real quick. Yeah, grapple just means like you just like.
I mean, we probably could have asked them like, "Oh, hey,
bear hugging
niggas know where the cockatrice is, probably," but I don't know.
But we didn't know what about the cockatrice until we.
That's very true too. They could have told us, is there anything in this fucking cave? Oh, yeah, I don't know. Maybe a cockatrice. Have you seen the claw marks? Oh, okay.
It always helps to interview them.